Oh, hello, everybody. Welcome to the Guild. I just hit my mic. Welcome to the Guild D&D. Yay. How you guys doing? We are back and we are so happy to be here. We did one charity campaign where you guys helped us raise $40,000. And we had some sponsors reach out to want to do a little bit more. So we are so fortunate to be sponsored for the next four Sundays by XSplit. And if you don't know XSplit, XSplit is an interface where it just makes it easy for you to start streaming. So you can add your game box. You could do a lot of different things, configuring the way that your live stream looks, and you don't really have to do as much fiddling as you normally would. And it's really easy. So if you guys want to try out XSplit, do us a favor. Click on that sort of XSplit get 10% off with the guild code. That'll help us look really nice for our sponsor. And other than that, we're just going to have a great time tonight. We really appreciate, God, there are a lot of people in chat. I'm really excited about that. This is a Sunday in quarantine. So everybody, Amy Okuda's here. Everybody introduce themselves, starting with Amy going around.
Hi, I'm Amy.
Great.
I don't know. I'm going to play Tink. Whatever.
I'm Jeff. I'm playing Dvorak.
Hi, I'm Vince Casso. I'm playing Blades.
Hi, I'm Robin Thorson, and I'm playing Clara. Yay!
Hey, I'm Sunday Preak, and I'm playing Zabu.
And I'm Amy Warpall, and I'm the Dungeon Master.
Woohoo! Yay! Behind the scenes are our mods, who will be giving away some XSplit codes at intermission, and Ryko, my producing partner, and Sean Becker, who is running all the tech. He is the director of seasons 2 through 5 and one of my very awesome collaborators, and he is doing all the tech here. So anything that goes wrong, blame Sean.
anyway. Big scapegoat.
Exactly. Oh my gosh. Amy, we're thrilled to have you back. Thank you for guiding us through a 4-part arc adventure.
Mm. Yeah, this is gonna be really exciting. I decided that the one we did for charity was so much fun that I wanted to extend it and see what else could happen in this fun world of Dragonor with the mushroom folk. So we will be picking up where we left off. If any of you are very confused, I have a quick recap for you, but also you can go to the Guild's YouTube and watch the whole playthrough for free and kind of get caught up. It was a damn treat, let's just say that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, amazing.
Absolutely.
It was good. It was
so many mushrooms.
And to be clear, all of us are playing our characters. So I'm playing Codex, Amy's playing Tink, everybody's playing their in-game characters, but not their
real said that
from the guild.
We all said that, Felicia.
I know, but I don't want there's one person who's confused.
I understand. I'm confused.
Hey, yeah. Timmy, this is for you. This one person. We're all playing.
All right, pull him into the Zoom call. Let's talk about this.
Felicia, do you wanna pimp out our cool overlay that we have for any of the hardcore D&D fans who want to know what's going on with the characters?
We do. That was why we were started 5 minutes late. We were trying to get the D&D overlay, and it wasn't Sean's fault or the D&D overlay's fault. It was basically I have two different D&D on Beyond accounts, and it was just we were being wonky. So the awesome thing is that you could click on the overlay. And you can see our hit points update live as long as all of us remember to update on the D&D Beyond. And you can also see all of our stats and all that stuff. So you can kind of keep up with that. That is a really cool feature on D&D Beyond right now. And they also launched a little dice rolling thing. But I'm using my real dice. So there you go.
Yeah, it's really addicting. We were playing with the overlay in rehearsal. And it's really hard not to just have your screen open on that the whole time. But to get to it, you just kind of hold your cursor, hover over the left side of it, and it'll all pop out and you can click on each character. Did you say that?
I don't know. No, I probably didn't.
Okay, great. Well, without further ado, let's jump back in.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yay.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to read a quick little thing about what happened last time to refresh mainly
Jeff's
the
memory,
but also why not?
To refresh Jeff.
To refresh Jeff, I'm going to.
He's not that old. Come on.
I'm old as dirt. Let's just. Okay.
It all began with a tear-off tab on a flyer in Mondopolis, the capital city of Dragonor. Okay. The Knights of Good, arguably not yet an adventuring party, or at least not a convincing one, arrived in Bumble Hollow to help the mayor shaman Thrashin Cedar Pal rid her small, swampy town of mushroom folk. They had infested the town and were crying all the time. Thrashin and Codex bonded over being non-confrontational. Vork was down to kill the mushroom folk to solve the problem. Blades thought they might be good to eat. Tink was on board. Clara wasn't really. Babu just wanted to lick them. That was about an hour.
Come on.
That did take an hour. It took an hour for that.
It took us 20 minutes to figure out who had the tab of paper.
It took us about 15 minutes just to describe Vork's hair.
Yeah. Oh my God, yes.
It was black and gold.
Worth it.
It was
beautiful. So they quickly learned the mushroom folk have short lifespans, only 1 week, and they spent their entire lives reproducing. That's the mushroom folks. The guild talked to the mushroom folk, Cinnamon the sexy femme mushroom, who was offended by Zabu's mushroom face disguised self that failed. Funguscus the sexy masculine mushroom, who was taken by Tink and produced spores with her. And Rubu, the middle child mushroom.
Rubu!
Who quickly became the team's mascot after almost dying in Blades' care.
Well, okay.
It happened. Rubu led the adventurers to the mushroom folks' home, the Sporgy Spore Tree. This tree was invaded by a creepy, voyeuristic, evil presence, which forced the mushrooms to relocate to Bumble Hollow. So the guild assumed if they rid the evil from the tree, they could help the mushrooms move back to their tree and fulfill Thrashen's request. Inside the roots of the tree, a pool of viscous fluid contained newborn spores, which Rubu called brothers and sisters. Mm. As the guild investigated the place, Clara ventured forth further into the cavern and was attacked by the demon. A huge battle ensued involving a demon and Vork makeout session, an illusion Vork naked with an erection, and a lot of damage.
For the kids.
The children watching.
Most of the damage was done.
It was a PG erection.
What is that even?
Definitely unoffensive. And, oh my God. Cute. It was a cute erection. Okay.
It was like a Pixar.
Pixar erection.
It cried a lot. Most of the damage that was done particularly to the demon's butt, his red satin speedo, and the contents within. Anyway, they finally defeated him, and Rubu laid down with the illusion Vork. Fade out on that. Tink and Funguscus decided to go their own ways. Funguscus presented her with a pot of awakening, which she passed off to Blades, right in a pretty conspicuous re-gifting situation. As a gift, Thrash and Cedar Pal thanked the group with a choice of a house built by Jasper Nevermuddy, who she was obsessed with, in Bumble Hollow, or 25 gold pieces.
Ooh.
A lot of discussion there, like 30 minutes of discussion. Finally, Thrash and performed a ritual which put a stamp on the group as an actual adventuring party. Yay! Yes. And as a thing that I just want to start doing, my favorite YouTube comment of this last posting of this video was from Nicholas Epsilon 3. He said, contemplating genocide, drug trips, fungal sporgies, erecting naked Fabios. They do it for the kids, though.
It's true.
It's us.
It's so creepy.
It was just like, why did I even write a summary? He did it.
Yeah, he did it. Pithy. More pithy.
Okay, so if no one has any more questions, I think it's time to part the veil of reality. Yes, and we're no longer stuck away from each other, really. We're not separated by LED screens and computers and monitors and technology. No. We are back in Bumble Hollow, actually. And we remember the mushrooms did move back to their Sporgy Spore Tree. They offered you room and board in their tree, but you preferred Thrashen's offer to stay for free in a large yurt-like lodge, which is basically just a round tent, overnight in Bumble Hollow. It's big enough for the six of you, but it's quaint, and it has some screens separating the beds. At the end of the night, you did learn two things before you went to bed. One, Jasper Nevermuddy promised to begin building your houses the very next day. And two, there is going to be a funeral for Funguscus the next morning when you wake up. Oh. So as the morning begins, you've all healed, gotten your spell slots back, and you follow a short procession of a few dozen mushrooms of all sizes to send off Funguscus. And I'm assuming you're all in agreement with that, unless you're not.
I'm like, all for it.
We want to go to the funeral? Like, is he, are we carrying his body? Did they cut him up? What's going on?
No, I'm a pallbearer, aren't I? Yeah, Cinnamon and Rubu actually were the ones who invited you. And they presented it like not really a big deal, but for some of the most beloved, you know, people are dying all the time in this community. So for beloved people, or it's really just anyone who wants to come, but it's kind of a quick, there's not really a ceremony. It's just kind of a nice showing of faith. And he kind of did request.
Yeah, I'm there for it. Absolutely.
He's okay, my great. Boyfriend. I have to go.
So, but they die every week, right?
Yeah, like, yeah, once a week.
A lot of ceremonies.
These happen.
Yeah, their lifespan, again, is just 1 week. So right. As you do arrive, they lead you, this procession led by some mushrooms, don't really know, but Rubu and Cinnamon kind of stick with you. And as you arrive, you do see, it's deeper into the forest from the spongy spore tree, and it's just a huge, it's just a big pile, and it's unclear what the pile is made of, but it looks a little sturdier actually at the top of the pile. And if you do look more closely, you can see that this is just a pile of dead mushrooms. So the bottom is like slowly disintegrating into the ground, and the top is packed with fresh mushrooms who have gone there to die.
I mean, so many of these guys die every day. You kind of have to just toss them out.
Put them in a pile.
It's a compost pile.
This is a compost pile.
It's ecological, yeah.
I never thought of my compost pile as a mass grave before, but this is going to change my perspective.
It's the Costco of piles.
Wait for the rest of this campaign. Yeah, actually, it is called the compost pile. That is what they call it. And mostly mushroom folk are kind of gathered around in a circle, a half circle, and Fungus is kind of standing close to the pile.
He's standing, even though he's not dead? He's not dead yet?
No, he's not dead yet.
Oh, no!
What? Watch him die?
Wait, so this is not a funeral. This is like an execution.
No. He's going
to he's going to die.
These guys die on schedule.
Yeah, it's consensual.
But you don't watch someone die at a funeral.
Oh, my God. Doing the mushroom world. It's
yeah, I guess.
Guys, hey, everybody, stop being such assholes. We got
no. I'm here for it.
Sensitive here, okay?
Listen, we're the only. This is not what I signed up for. I thought he was going to be dead.
No, this is really awkward. But there are no villagers here. They all die so frequently. It's just they're phoning it in at this point, right? Yeah. No one's. We need to be here to support Fungus's imminent death.
Do we have to say something to him before he dies?
Like, yeah, can I talk to Fungus?
Should I let him spore on me?
Before you do, I do need to explain. You basically see a bunch of, not even a bunch, a handful of mushroom folk, but you also see four humanoids kind of standing off to at the end of the semicircle. They're not mushroom folk. They actually look pretty organized. They're all wearing different shades with highlight, like orange with orange, sorry, black with orange highlights on their clothing.
Do I recognize them? Can I do would it be an insight or a history?
No, I will say you don't recognize them, but Clara, you do. There, it's a dragonborn, two halflings, and a dwarf. And Clara, you recognize the two halflings. You went to grade school with the two halflings.
Oh, I knew that looked familiar.
Yeah, but now, yes, you are, as you approach, you know, Cinnamon doesn't look really sad. Everyone's a bit kind of apathetic, like this is just what happens. I guess not apathetic, but matter of fact. And Rufus, yeah, just sitting there, just kind of looking around and waiting. Fungus is still standing there, and he waves to you and says, "Hey guys, my friends.
Hey, how you holding up, buddy?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm about to pass on to the moist, damp cavern in the sky, man."
Do you know like exactly when it's happening?
Around now. So in a bit, I'm just going to kind of jump up to the top of this pile and
Blades wants to set his VCR.
Just, you know, I wonder how long we're going to be here.
Has someone ever jumped on the pile and like missed, like it just done the ceremony and then missed
like
the mark?
Rolled down?
Like, well, just rolled down. Yeah, that would be awkward. But also just like, and here I go. And then they didn't really, it took like a couple hours.
Oh, no. I mean, honestly, when I'm at the top of the pile, I still might not die, but you guys are free to go whenever. It's like top of the pile is kind of the end.
Do you have any
last
unfinished
wishes?
Business?
Okay, yeah.
Or that?
Actually, yeah. I mean, I'm glad you guys asked. I'm glad you guys are here. The big thing I'm looking to do is admit something.
Oh, wow.
What?
Oh. Admit something? Is that
you
what
he said? Gus, yeah. You can tell us anything.
Anything.
And he looks right at Tink and said, you know, I know I came off a little chill and cool about dying in a week, but since I laid eyes on you, I realized if I had my choice, I'd live longer, man. I want to live longer.
For Tink?
For me?
Okay. That's a choice.
Well, you can't. He's done.
Do you know her very well? I mean, well, you know.
What's wrong with me?
We all know exactly how much I know her, but she made an impact.
Have you lived with her?
Because I'm cool.
Okay, Tink, you need to walk up to the top of the pile with him.
No. Absolutely.
No, come on.
You have to see him.
Disgusting. Give a speech. What is wrong with you?
Speech.
You should give a speech.
You need to lay with him on the pile.
Speech.
You go.
He's about to die, and you are his one love. Listen, he doesn't have a lot of brains. Look at him.
Tink, you've known him for like 30% of his whole life. Think about that.
That's
true.
That's
true.
Are you going to give me something? I'll do it. I'll do it if one of you gives me like, I don't know. I'll take like 10 gold.
10 gold?
Just do it? 10 gold?
Care about the goodness of your heart.
I'll give you a 10 gold.
Tink, just do it. How about 10 gold like from everybody? So it's just like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
Oh, so it's a bargain?
Can't you just do it?
You want
this is a money at zero.
It's disgusting. You want me to jump on a pile of
dirt.
Rotting mushrooms?
Make a shroom. Tink, make a shroom.
Tink.
What?
Tinky.
That's a new one.
Wait, are we married to that?
That's a new one.
Tinky.
What? Yes.
All right. Tinky Bay. Tinky Bay.
I don't like that name. Don't call me that.
All right. Look.
Tinky the Pink? just throwing out some ideas. All just right. Spitball.
I'm not going to make you do anything you don't want to do. I am leaving this material plane, but there's a bigger quest out there. I can't save myself. I'm really dying, but I realized that I want to give a gift to the rest of my generation and my progeny. And he winks at Rubu. And he says,
I hate Rubu.
That's his child.
Well, that's
he's
his
about to die. Well,
that's his baby girl.
Listen, guys.
This is literally his last word.
He likes Tink's honesty, so just let her be.
Yeah, I mean, I like how she calls it like it is. But look,
hey, Fungus, Gus.
There once, what?
Is there something you can give me if I go up there with you?
God.
You're really baby. Pushing that.
I was bad.
I don't have much, you know, like I'm a mushroom, so.
You can't overstate it.
Like, how about this? You can, when I'm gone, I would not be offended. I'll point out the tastiest part of me and you can chop it right off and have it for dinner.
I'm kind of into it.
That's pretty good.
Love it.
For it.
You're not going to find a better offer.
We need a quest.
But just make sure it's dead. Make sure I'm dead before you.
Okay.
So here's the thing. There is an artifact that can prolong our life, and it's called the Trident of Fibrous Tissue.
Oh, that's just
that's a rough name.
I needed a workshop.
It rolls off my tongue.
It rolls off my tongue.
Really does. And so a long time ago, generations ago, and that would be probably about 10 weeks.
10 minutes.
Generations, man. A long time. We lost our trident of fibrous tissue. Now, it let us live longer and I mean, this is just passed down lore, so let us live longer. It in itself produced riches of gold and gems that replenished every day, and no mushroom folk was for want. And I want to get that back, and I don't really know.
How much longer are we talking?
What do you mean?
Like, how much longer would you guys live with that thing?
I think like 2 weeks.
Holy
wow,
shit.
Wow.
That's a lot.
2 weeks longer.
2 weeks longer.
Triple
your
lifespan.
Yeah, triple my lifespan.
That's
incredible.
That's wild.
Now, about the endless gold that it creates, how does that
I do agree with that.
Clarify that?
Yeah, I mean, I've never seen it. This was my great, 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 grandfather.
Holy crap, that's months ago.
Well, so yeah, that's why, by the way, that is why it's called the Spore G tree, because we actually don't really say great that many times. We use scientific notation.
Wow.
G times 10 to the whatever.
Okay. Sounds scientific. Okay.
Yeah, it's scientific notion.
So,
yeah.
So this was G times 10 to the 10th 10 weeks ago. My great, you know.
That's a number.
10. Okay, so if Tink goes with you to the top of the pile of dead relatives, then you'll give us the where to get this quest, even though it won't save your life.
Okay, this is a little bit awkward because I didn't know if you guys were going to come or not, but do you see those guys down there?
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
those were the people I actually knew this, you know, I was going to die soon. And I put out a quest for them to come help me. They're actual adventurers.
What are we, chop liver?
No, I just didn't know. You know, you guys came into the picture literally a day ago.
That's fair.
You double booked?
What are you talking about? Could you have canceled them by pigeon or something?
I think, are we the backup?
Yeah, you're the backup, but I'll let you have the quest. I'll give you the info if Tink, if you climb up to the top.
Okay, Tink, you have to go.
Yeah, absolutely. I will not be upstaged by them.
They have matching outfits.
Okay, then I get 10% more gold than whatever we find.
Just go to the pile.
Just do it.
Or no.
Yes, even if you don't do it, just say yes now so I feel better about doing it now.
Okay, we'll give you anything, but we don't mean it.
Tink will give you all
totally
of the gold.
We're totally insincere about it.
True. I'm not think behind my it. Back crossing my fingers. Yes.
You think about it.
As far as you know, we'll give you whatever you want.
I promise it'll cross my mind.
The other adventuring group is watching you guys like this. Like,
God, they know they're better than us. God.
He's kind of hot though.
No, they all look amazing.
Okay,
they all look amazing.
God damn it.
Beautiful thighs.
Clara, I know this is awkward to ask, but do you know those halflings since you're a halfling yourself?
Yeah, we went to school together.
Great school.
Wow, I didn't want to assume all halflings knew each other.
Do you have any, like,
it's a blur, info? But...
Did you lose your virginity?
They just seem very nice. Did I what? That's nothing. Personal.
I think you told that story, though.
Just, conversations ended there. Wow.
That kind of guys. I don't cousin tell.
He's blushing.
Maybe Clara can go, like, talk to them, get some intel on them.
Yeah, get their... see what kind of equipment they have. Yeah. Just so maybe
they don't seem that intimidating to me.
Okay.
Just talk to them.
Gus does say to the rest of you, like, hey guys, I like how you bargain, and I love Tink how you don't put up with any BS. You know, you just say what's on your mind. Thing about these material goods of riches and gems and gold is we mushrooms actually don't have any need for them. So as long as we get that trident of fibrous tissue, anything material that it produces can be yours till the end of days.
Okay, fine. I'll fucking go. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh my gosh.
This person's about to die.
Okay,
just to be
Fungus Gus, let's go, my lover.
Okay, so Fungus.
That's not at all.
She really,
take two. Can we have take two?
Now
please?
It's okay that you go up there. Now it's okay.
So Fungus Gus reaches out what looks like a hand. Like a leafy kind of...
Is it still like a lot? It's like not decaying yet.
It is decaying, yeah.
Ugh.
Touch it. You gotta take his hand.
Don't
take it.
You're
it's an optics
doing
thing.
Don't
be squeamish.
You're doing it for the team.
In front of his face.
All right,
it looks good.
Hold on to it. All right.
A towel.
Yeah, fine.
Did she get a towel out?
Do we not all have a towel? I have a towel.
Amy, roll.
I forgot mine.
Roll.
I have a +2 towel.
I didn't hear you. I didn't hear
plus
you.
+2 to absorption.
Roll a strength check.
Strength check. Oh boy.
Oh gosh. 1.
Okay. If
No. Wait. Please stop. It's a it was a 7.
But you rolled on the die a 1.
No. It looked like a 1, but it was a 7.
Okay. Still, that's. And then if you add your strength. No, that's all. That's what it was.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, it it's still holding on, but it kind of falls off into your
hand. Just grit your teeth.
You recoil a bit, but he looks at you and is like, man, I really appreciate this, babe. This is so great. And you like crunch and your feet sink in. I mean, this is like deep, soggy, like deciduous fucking.
Oh, I'm so glad Tink is doing this.
Yeah. And as you climb up, I mean, you kind of get to the top. It's really tall. This might be probably like 12 feet high. He himself is 8 feet high, so it's double his height.
Jesus.
And he's like climbing up and he's able to stay on the surface, but you're, by the time he's at the top, you're pretty neck deep in this stuff.
Oh my God, she's
neck deep? Wait, neck?
Wow, that's in there.
I mean, it's decaying, you know, it's decaying mulch.
Guys, I think we owe her the gold at this point.
You guys owe me the gold. What is wrong with you? What do you mean you think?
I mean, yeah.
Anybody have a spell that can clear her off? Wait, do we have a spell? I don't have a spell.
If I did, I wouldn't use it.
Oh boy. I wish I had a cantrip of cleaning. I don't. I'm so sorry.
Does anyone have prestidigitation? No?
Cool. I can Eldritch Blast it off.
I'll do it.
That'd be good.
Like, that's like using a power washer on like a very soft baby.
just chunks.
Can I put it on my shoulder or something?
Well, she's already in there, man.
Yeah, eventually you can. Funguscus lays down resolute, and he looks over. Your head is kind of right by his now. I mean, the pile continues, but your head is here, and the pile continues on. And he just looks at you and says, anything you could tell me to make this passage a little smoother? Baby.
Anything at all.
Anytime.
You expect me to talk right
You're
now?
You're lying.
Is that what you say?
I think you just say anything.
Really, you're not saying anything.
Think of the mountains of gold.
I love your giant sunglasses. They made you look really hot.
That's sweet.
Complimentary. That's not bad. Complimentary.
That was said sincerely.
Yeah. And you're... Nice. No, wait.
Okay.
Oh,
no.
Get in there.
Oh, your lips are decaying too.
Yes,
oh my God. No. Fungus, I probably would have done this a day ago, but literally you're like,
his lips are
OTP.
Like,
okay.
You're like not all there. You
yeah, kiss all right.
Kiss him.
Just give him the cheek or something.
I feel like you should give him a kiss.
No, I can take a hint. I can take a hint. And he kind of rolls over.
Oh, what a way to go.
Gives you a shoulder.
I was kidding. I just got really shy. You know, I got scared because I.
There you go.
Get in there, girl.
They did it.
Oh my God, they're making out. Did I see a tongue go in there?
Oh, she's doing a town.
Wow.
Codex, if you ever want to practice.
So cute.
Awesome. You know what? I'm going to pass on that cutest one. But I would make out with Fungus Gus before you. I'm so sorry.
I get it. He's great.
Awesome.
I'm learning.
Very good. Yeah. Darlington.
Oh,
I'm taking notes.
Did he just die?
Oh, yeah, he died.
Oh. Oh my God.
Well, does
anyone care how I feel right now?
Not so much.
You just kissed a mushroom to death.
No, I kissed him because that was his dying wish. I didn't kiss him and then he died because of the kiss.
Okay, does somebody have a rope? I'm going to throw a rope up there. I have a rope. I'm not going up there, but I do have a rope in my inventory. I'm going to throw it up there and everybody help me.
I have a bag of sand.
Left lasso, or get it around her neck.
What would that do?
Bag of sand.
Add some weight to the end of the rope. Hell yeah. Okay.
Oh, I see.
Heck yeah, Felicia. Roll a acrobatics check.
Okay, acrobatics check.
Did Fungus Gus give me anything before he died? I mean,
he gave you the time of your life.
Some sweet time.
13.
Oh, yeah. Oh, 13. Yeah, you can definitely wrap it around her. The only thing that's, it's like her shoulders. And yes, sorry, Tink, he did. He put a piece of paper into your pocket.
Oh, okay.
Is that a euphemism?
Like a note?
Not a euphemism. This one's not going to be as dirty.
Thank you.
No, we're here.
Let's try.
So many children.
But yes, Felicia, you're able to lasso her around her shoulders.
Okay, everybody, help me pull her out. Okay.
Yeah, no, we got this. Here we go.
Okay, great.
Behind you.
Okay.
Just a little bit more room, Zabu, please.
Okay, just.
I'm pulling loosely.
Yeah, like
come on, everybody.
She flies out like a zit being popped.
It made a noise.
Outside of the mulch pile.
Oh my God.
Well, acne.
Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, stop it. Okay.
She smells like puke. Oh, just for the record, she smells like puke.
Yeah, she does not. She does not smell great. The other guild, the other mushroom folk are kind of like, you know, that was great. Rubu goes, I'm Rubu. Bye, Fungus Gus. I'm Rubu. And they kind of dissipate. But the other guild approaches you guys.
Oh boy.
All right. Come
so there's a dragon and two dragonkin and two halflings?
Yep, a dragonborn, two halflings, and a dwarf.
Oh. I try to look very, very, very tough, very intimidating.
Okay, guys.
And you don't really. Why don't I? Can I stand in front?
Can someone clean me or something?
Try to get in front of Codex to make sure they're not making eyes at her.
Do I still smell?
Yes, this just happened.
Yes. Get in the back.
You're nasty. Yeah.
You're nasty. I'm going to get in front.
Get behind us.
Okay, who's it?
We're getting the front.
I'm in front.
I'm next to Vork. Just.
Okay, so the
we're all trying to pose really cool around Vork.
Oh, you're posing really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah,
trying to. It's really not working, but we're trying.
I'm pulling my flaxen hair back.
Okay, perfect. they're all kind of trying to look cool as well.
Having a cool pose off.
Actually, there's a halfling in front who looks like she's running the show. Her name, Clara. You would know her name is Guinevere.
Guinevere.
Yeah, and you guys were semi pals. Like, you don't really have any bad blood that you know of. I mean, but it also has been a very long time. And the other halfling is named Mallory Pocket Moon. So you know both of them. They were both in your kind of friend group growing up.
Right.
But it has been quite a while. So, but Guinevere goes, hey, what was that? Did y'all take our quest away?
Your quest.
Yeah.
It's kind of like gifted to us.
Yeah, pretty sure it's our quest now.
Yeah, I fucking smell like vomit for it. It's our quest. It's my quest.
You know, I'm so sorry that you guys came so far. You know, he actually sent a pigeon after you to cancel the request. Yeah. You know how long those take, and you know, griffins eat them out of the sky and all that stuff. Yeah. So,
in fact, before he died, Duska specifically told us you guys were the backup, and we were the number one for this quest. So we had some time, we made it work. So here we are.
Wait, y'all are. Hey, Clara,
Gwen,
you were. You were like just starting up an adventuring group.
Yeah.
And this is it?
This is it.
That's us.
We're here.
Oh my gosh. That is wild. You know, I was really so inspired by you when I heard that you were doing that.
That's so nice.
That's
why
I even formed these guys.
No way.
Wait, are y'all the Knights of Good?
You're the Knights of Good, yes.
You heard of us.
Our reputation precedes us.
That's
good intentions.
That's us. Clara, we named our group the Crusaders of Better.
It sounds a little bit derivative, honestly.
Why don't you call yourselves Poopy?
That's fine.
That's a good dig.
Wait, cool. What?
Wow, Vork, fucking killing it, buddy.
Wait, Vork. Yeah, Vork, I've heard so much about you. What did you say just now?
Why don't you call yourselves Poopy?
Yeah, I don't.
Down.
It just doesn't have the same ring to it. No, but like, we're inspired by you guys.
Well, that's great. So you started your group after I started... You know, we all did it. So.
Yeah. So, okay. I mean, do you want to trade war stories? What have you guys done?
Oh boy.
We got a spork. We retrieved a spork from a dragon.
Yeah. I was two people at once, and one was much more attractive.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I mean, we kind of defeated a big evil force by summoning an Empyrean from the celestial sky.
No one cares.
Oh, we've killed gods.
No,
I've been buck naked in the talons of a wyvern. Yeah. So
what's the name of the god that you killed?
You know
with the deities.
We beat it so hard, it was wiped from memory. Eliminated.
The god became nameless after we killed it.
Yeah, nameless gods. That's how we created those. That's we so created the nameless gods. Yeah.
Okay. Anyone taking those names. Doing this, I want a deception check.
Okay, fine.
Okay, deception check. All right.
Is that for everybody?
Wait. Who has the best deception? Because I can actually aid you.
I've got a plus four.
Okay, so I'm going to aid. I'm going to do my cantrip guidance, and that's going to give once before the spell. Touch one willing creature once before the spell ends. The target can roll a d4 and add the number to an ability check.
Okay.
So I'm going to touch blades.
Huh.
You can roll and add it to your roll.
Okay, then that comes out to a total of, wow, 22.
Dang. Yeah. Okay, great.
Are we all doing it or just Blades?
I guess you're all, let's just say you're all aiding Blades.
Okay.
Yes.
Because no big deal.
Okay, yeah, they rolled really high, but not high enough. They had an 18 on the die. But so it's like they go, you killed a deity?
Wasn't easy.
Yeah.
Oh, for us, it was easy, but it's not easy, you know?
Yeah, and the deity was like a
That is like a dick. So metal.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it inspires you to go do your own deity and get away from this quest, because this is such small beans for us, mm-hmm. but we're just like doing it as a favor to her lover.
Yeah, we go way back with Gus Dose. Good, so.
Like, yeah.
We were free for the last 10 minutes.
It's just like, I mean, we did travel 3 days to get here. Like, he did order us. So on it, I mean, here's the thing.
Hey, asshole. Did you kiss Gus? I don't think so. Go home.
Gus.
Whatever.
She makes a compelling point.
I call him Gus. Yeah. He was my lover.
What if you guys just stay in? We have some houses that are being built. You guys can stay for free for a week at our place and just enjoy the...
For free? I mean...
For a discounted rate. That's very fair.
Thank you. No towels. No free towels. No.
We took all the towels.
Continental breakfast.
I mean, we didn't bring our own towel. Look, hey, I mean, come on. You have to understand that this is kind of unfair, right? We were about to... Can we come with you? Can we just have the sheet of paper that he put in your freaking pocket?
What is this, a band? It's a band? It's not just us.
I mean, listen, we killed a deity, all right? I wouldn't rustle us.
Oh.
You know what? Hang on, guys. Hang on. Can we just, 1 second, I'm going to grab everybody and like sidebar. Hang on, 1 second. Sorry. Guys, what if we just, I don't know. I do feel, okay, come on, hear me out. I feel kind of bad. What if we just let them tag along? Like, what's it going to hurt?
Why would we do that? Robin.
Do we have to split that?
I mean, I still think go with them. You go home with them.
Maybe we can teach them something. Maybe they can learn from us.
No.
Clara,
this is our second quest.
Clara, I have something
to say. You don't have to know that.
Yeah.
All right,
I want everyone to know that I have the freaking piece of paper from Gus.
Oh God, Tink has all the power right now.
Yeah. So do we know? We all just basically have to do what I say.
Okay.
Well,
should we look at what the paper says?
Yeah. Why don't we read the paper?
Yeah. Let's look at the paper.
Can I read the paper without anybody seeing it? I would like to read the paper in private.
Make a.
No, we'll all read it, but make sure the other people don't hear it.
I think that'll be fine. Yeah. If you're huddled up and
we'll be right with you. Sorry.
You're definitely keeping an eye out on them, making sure they don't get too close. So yeah, you don't have to roll for that. You can definitely look at it. It also isn't very, it's a thick piece of paper. And it's kind of written in more goo than ink, but it says, follow the origin to find where the trident was taken. Follow the origin to find where the trident was taken.
Follow the origin to find where the trident was taken.
Would that be back at the Sporgy, maybe?
Taken.
That
playing a sound bath right now. Is somebody trying to scry?
I heard that. It's so calming.
It's my doorbell. Sorry.
Is that your doorbell?
It's my doorbell.
Oh my God.
It's the sound of a quest being acquired. We have a new quest now.
Exactly. We have a quest.
Oh, great.
So origin. Bing bong. Boom.
Okay. Listen, why would the origin? What would we know? Can I do like a cultural check or about
I'll say who thinks they know this area around?
I've got a +5 history. Well, I'm a forest gnome and I've got +5 to history.
Okay. I'm also proficient in history, so I'd love to have a crack at it.
Have survival.
Or survival.
Okay, so we all should just do checks. Okay.
Okay, great.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'll just roll it on this thing.
I'm gonna do a survival check.
Okay, I got a
history.
God damn it. I got a 10.
11.
I'm going to do survival.
Perfect.
Am I doing a history check too?
If you want to, yeah. History or
do
survival.
Do whatever you got more of.
Robin, you too.
I got 16.
I only have pretty good survival in that. 6.
9.
And did anyone get higher than a 15 besides Vork?
Me? I got 15.
Okay, Vork, it's unclear if you... Oh, you did?
Yeah, I got 15.
Blades? Okay. So, Blades, you know you heard of the origin somewhere, but you're not sure where. Jeff, you have a little bit more information. You passed something called like a company. It seems like you passed a company that was called Origin something. You can't really remember what, on your way to Bumble Hollow from Mondopolis. So that was a one-day trip. You guys all walked, and
I did see something.
Yeah, you saw like a sign called Origin something.
Origin.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so okay. Bork, so
what
we should
know?
What do you know?
What do you know? You saw something?
I saw a sign that said Origin. I just can't say anymore.
You can't remember anymore. This is it was like a billboard or advertising something.
It's kind of in the peripheral, like in the side of the corner of my eye. I just saw this big wooden sign said Origin.
Oh, like one of the billboards on the road the way down here.
That's exactly what I just said. Yes.
Yeah.
I can't. Right. Yes. It's
well. What we need to do is go there, but we can't let these other yo-yos see us. We can't let them see us.
I think Clara's got to do some kind of a distraction. She knows them.
Clara, you got to take them off her scent.
Work some angle.
I'll talk to them. Like,
what do they like? What is Guinevere?
I don't know.
What do Guinevere like?
A little bit. They were kind of mean girls, but I mean, whatever.
Okay.
Can you also ask Gwenny if she has any like wipies or something?
Here, let me get some. I'm just gonna get some leaves and start.
I'm gonna pull my towel out. I'm gonna start toweling Tink off.
Oh, thank you.
Maybe you can tempt them with somebody else to bully. They were mean girls.
Yeah. Okay, wait. Lie to them and tell them. Okay, okay. Somebody lie to them and say them that Thrashen actually has the quest, and so they need to go to town and get the quest from Thrashen.
Oh yes, Clara, do it.
I like it. Classic misdirect.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm so candy.
Say it again, because I wasn't listening.
You're so. It's only 9 a.m. Are you drunk already?
Maybe.
Tink smells bad, but I can still smell the booze on Clara's breath.
It's
pretty intense.
I have my jug of stuff. Anyways, okay, what did you say?
She's got a jug she's got a jug, and it's about the size, I mean, she's a halfling, so it's about the size of her head. And
how did we miss that?
You've seen this a while, and you just every once in a while hear her whisper to it, and it's normally something like vodka or beer or whatever.
Wine.
Wine. Yeah, she'll just.
Oh, there's magic afoot here.
Wow. Yeah, and then it appears. It's great. It's the greatest thing.
Wow.
But what shall I tell them to do?
Okay, just tell them that the mayor has the quest for them, and that we're gonna go. We actually have a more important quest to go do, and then they can have it. They just got to go to the mayor to get the info. Okay, and then we'll run.
Oh, they're gonna run out of town.
And we're running.
Then we're gonna run afterwards.
That just seems okay. Yep.
We can pull it off.
We can do this. This is great. Totally. I read it in a romance novel. It worked then. And
this is classic Knights of Good.
The elf and the ogre totally got together.
I think it'll work.
Okay.
Okay. Also, Clara, I want to just remind you, and I hope this doesn't sound like patronizing or condescending, but you do have some spells that could help you in this
venture. I do.
That's so patronizing.
Yeah. So I'm just basing on what.
Why don't you look those over? And meanwhile, let's figure out what the hell Amy just had delivered from her Postmates or whatever.
Yeah, Tink, what are you eating?
What did you have your man slave bring you?
It smells great.
It really does.
Oh, it's just pizza.
Spell, right?
Oh, a suggestion spell.
I can do that.
Yeah, suggestion spell is perfect.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I'm going to tell Guinevere to go on a different quest.
Okay, correct? And
No,
they have to go into town.
Clara needs to. They need to go. Listen,
you need Felicia to explain it to
you.
Not
gonna details. She's got a roll with hitting the house.
That was the wrongest interpretation of what I said ever.
Okay, all right.
The wrongest.
Go tell them.
Okay.
Let's practice it. Yeah, here.
Go tell Guinevere that they need to go to the
Clara walks up all sassy with her, and she's like, "Guinevere, you hold on." Guinevere, hold on a second.
Oh my god.
Hold on, Guinevere. And she like goes back to the group, and Guinevere's like, "What's going on?"
Go tell them that the mayor has the quest for them and we have a more important quest, so they can go ahead and take this quest, but then we're just lying. Let me just say, tell Guinevere to go to mayor for quest.
Okay. Guinevere, I think you, hey Gwen, I think you should go to the mayor for a quest, that quest.
Okay. Okay,
we're all like, we're all back there. Just like,
and at that moment, so Guinevere is about to like lay into you, like, I don't know what the what that means. That quest is this quest. But first, while she's laying into you, you cast your suggestion spell. Yeah. And you
didn't know how to do that.
That is a second level spell. So I need to make a wisdom saving throw. What is your spell save DC?
What on earth? Oh, 13.
Awesome. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay. She goes, I don't know what you're talking about. That quest that you're talking about is this quest. Y'all took it from us, and that sounds awesome, man. It sounds really good.
Right?
Yes. Okay, we're going to go get that quest, which sounds like so postmodern. I love that quest. We're going to get that quest in town from Mayor Thrashen, who I haven't met yet, but oh, she's awesome, right? Is she awesome?
She's totally awesome. Yes. She's the most awesome.
She's the best.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet her. Okay, so this... It lasts up to 8 hours.
That's just enough time.
And this isn't harming the person. So yeah, this is. Is there anything else that specified, or just go to the mayor to get that quest?
But yeah, add some more, Claire. Add some more.
Make her stay there.
Specifics.
Stay there.
They gotta stay the night. They gotta stay the night.
They gotta stay the night.
Well, first, I think you guys should stay, get acquainted with the whole village, the
they're tired. They're really
you
tired.
Guys seem a little, you know, tired. I think you should, you know, rest, take a little rest, take a little lie down, have a little lie down, and then, you know, do your quest.
Yeah.
All right, Clara, it's so good to see you. I love you. I can't wait. I mean, I like this new version of getting a quest where we're like learning about each other before we get a quest. It's almost like what happened with Tink and that guy, which I still have a funny feeling about.
No.
He's just move on.
But this way's better. This way's better. Yeah. I can tell.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Right? It totally is. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna make my way back to town, and I guess I'll see you guys later, or not.
Or not. I mean, I like the or not better, but
I feel great. This feels
you
great.
You should. You look great.
We all feel
great. And then we run.
Okay, yeah, and then you bolt. Awesome. As you run away, they're just kind of, you can tell that like the other three of this group weren't quite on board, but Guinevere's the leader, and she's chill as hell, and they wound up following her. Good use of the suggestion spell, but hold on. That was a second level spell, so first, roll a d20.
What is that?
Because this is wild magic. Remember?
Oh, right. So wait, what do I roll again? What do I roll again?
Roll a d20. Roll a 20-sided die.
Okay. Okay.
Get 100.
Nine. I got a 9.
You got a 9. Okay.
Yeah.
No. Wild magic only triggers on a 1. It's
okay. Well,
ha. I like how scared you got.
I haven't played one in a very long time.
No, it's fine. It only triggers on a 1, which was why I got so excited last time, because a 1 is very
difficult. Or an Amy 1, which is in 7. We all know.
Right.
It looked very similar.
Okay. Perfect. So
we're good.
You are good. You're on your way. Just a quick reminder, you're on your way to get the Trident of Fibrous Tissue, or at least find out where it might be. Based on the letter that you received from Fungus Gus, you have a sense that the only thing he knows is where it was seen last or where it was taken. So that's the origin, seems to be all that he knows. And you guys ran, right? Like you didn't talk to Rubu or Cinnamon or anything. You guys
just took off.
Don't we have Rubu with us?
No, she's big now.
She's a little bigger. She's closer.
Remember, she
to
had
like
a lot of intercourse.
A foot and a half.
She made love to other.
She made love to a lot of other people.
That's right.
She laid down with some people.
She's a woman.
She's
she
a woman
was of
now.
Age, according to
yes.
mushrooms.
Yes. She's of mushroom.
They grow up
mushroom
so fast.
Years. She was great. Of age. So yeah, you guys keep running. The other thing you know is this was lost generations ago, but in mushroom speak, that means about 10 weeks, so 2.5 months. And that all they know is that it extends their life and provides gold and riches beyond imagination. So as
not
you're
bad.
Walking, you do, Vork, you are able to sort of guide the same path back to Mondopolis. They're really, you guys went you followed the road basically.
Back to the sign.
Yeah, so you, yes. And you were able to see this
yes.
sign, and it said Origin
yes.
Organics. And it had
yes.
it had a picture of a human man in a straw hat, holding a pitchfork and kind of leaning on it like this.
And like a piece of straw in his mouth.
Is it like a trident?
Oh, it's like a...
Yeah, like, maybe. yeah, a pitchfork.
Maybe.
Oh, and he's holding up an apple,
yes.
just a big fruit. And,
oh, guys, it's a farm.
Yeah, Origin Organics.
Organics.
Wait,
it
I am famished.
It says it points a direction and says 10 miles this way.
Okay.
Miles.
Okay. 10 miles.
10 miles.
10 miles.
Okay.
I can do that.
Gotta get my running shoes on. Let's do this.
Does anybody have anything that we can move faster?
I have an unseen servant that can carry. Can carry one person. Can carry you, Codex, of course.
Oh, thank you. But I don't. I think it just as an aggregate, we want to move as fast as we can because that's a smart group. I don't know how you, Clara. I don't know how you were friends with them, but they are very smart and they're going to get on to us.
Well,
pretty fast.
You know,
pretty fast.
I can run fast with too few people.
It's an 8-hour spell. I think we're good for a bit.
10 miles.
I think we're hoofing it. Oh, 10 miles is not far. Let's do this.
10 miles isn't going to take 8 hours. Is that a thing? Is that
That's a mile an hour.
Well,
can
I will
find
say
a horse?
You have already traveled a part of the day.
Okay.
Like this was kind of halfway between. So yeah, you've traveled about half the day.
You've already done 10 miles.
Probably about five hours.
So we should keep going. We need to get there.
Yeah.
We're probably pretty beat. All right.
Yeah. I mean, and then again, like the spell lasts for 8 hours, but like they would still have to figure out what's going on. And you do know that they don't have the piece of paper that you have.
They don't
know. They have nothing to go off of, guys.
But I just don't want them to come find us.
But they could.
Yeah. Have we been covering our tracks?
How would they find us, though?
Yeah. Have you been covering your tracks?
Of course.
Yes.
That would add time. That would add time.
Yeah.
We've absolutely been covering our tracks.
I've definitely not.
What are you talking about?
I'm being honest. I'm in a hurry.
And Codex's tracks. For sure.
Yeah, I will
that,
say
that's right.
My tracks.
That's not just a simple like cartoony like wave a brush behind you. It is like you know making sure that you know you're walking on certain.
It's
probably.
I don't think we did that, but
off
I do.
Yeah.
I do have a amulet.
You did like 15 minutes.
I have an amulet of non-traceableness, so they can't. When you're wearing this amulet, you are hidden from divination magic. Would they be able to do, if somebody could do divination magic, would they need to know us? Because I could give this to Clara to wear so they can't divine her and then maybe they couldn't divine the rest of us. Do you know what I'm saying?
That would be pretty smart, yeah.
Okay, so Clara, I'm going to give you this. This is specifically for me to be protected against Zabu. Don't tell him. But
okay,
this will allow us
to- What was that?
I
heard my name.
What? No, nothing. I just am putting a pretty necklace around Clara's neck because she really was so clever back then. It's
well,
just
it
alone.
It won't be as pretty as it would be on you, but whatever you need to do.
Thank you. Okay, here you go, Claire. Just put it on. I will get that back.
You.
I will get that back. Okay.
For sure, we got it.
Okay, so it takes you another. Let's say, it takes you another 2 hours to get to the farm. Maybe an hour and a half if you're running a little bit.
Yeah, we're.
Vork, carry me.
We're strapping.
And you do find yourselves at the Origin Organic Farm.
Finally.
So what you see is it's about 5 acres of fields, and then you see just in the distance, not too far, there's the homestead. It's got a house and two barns. Like the house is facing the road, like where you are, and then the two barns are further back. And then the fields kind of continue all around. So the homestead's kind of in the middle of where these orchards and farms and trees and vines are.
I have a spell. Okay, so are we within like 1,000 feet of the barns and the house?
Yes, you are.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I have a spell called locate object. It's a second level spell.
Okay.
And it allows me to, well, I haven't seen it, so I can't.
That's okay. I mean,
what are the chances that it's already here? That's just the beginning.
Well, I don't
do
know.
Do your thing anyway.
Okay, I'm going to do it. It can locate a specific object, but I have to be able to see it. Alternatively, the pedals can locate the nearest object of a particular kind. Okay, so I'm going to be looking for a trident. I'm going to use my second level spell to locate a trident to see if it's on this farm.
To see if there's a trident on this farm. Okay. Yeah. You're specifically looking for, okay, so you close your eyes and you get kind of like a gridded matrixy vision of this farm. And it's black and then lines are kind of green and you kind of see the green lines take away the crops. So as the green lines kind of dance around the crops, then they immediately disappear. And you see them dance around the house itself and then it kind of erases like a computer. Same thing with the barns. They erase. Now we're going a little more detailed. And you see inside the barn, you actually see what like blinks in and out. It is a pitchfork. But it also disappears eventually as well. Closer out in the field near the scarecrow, there's another pitchfork, and that kind of blinks with uncertainty. It stays for a minute, but then that also gets deleted, and you're left with like escape of just the insides of your eyelids.
Mm. Okay, so I saw two pitchforks, which didn't necessarily look like tridents, or they could be a trident. I guess we could. There's one in the field and one in a barn. So we can investigate those to see if they're magic.
We might have to talk to the farmer to see if he knows.
Can we find somebody?
I was going to say, I love your inside the matrix face. Like,
it was awesome.
Like that? It's pretty
kind of
right?
A seizure, but it's beautiful.
You made some weird ass faces, Codex.
I've never done that spell before, and I was just excited. And
I love it. It looks
okay.
Calm
it
down.
Looks awesome. But I'm thinking that the guy has a sign, so he wants traffic.
Yes.
So maybe we should just go talk to him.
Okay, absolutely. Fine. That's fine too. You know.
Just throwing it out there.
No, listen, it's fine. I don't.
I'm sorry.
I want to do what Codex wants to do. Never mind. Sorry.
I already did it. There's two pitchforks. So let's go ask the guy if he has a trident.
Yeah, I mean, talking is a good plan A.
Yeah, let's ask him if he has a trident of infinite gold and if he'd give it to us.
No, we can ask him that like straight up.
Yeah, yeah, not like, you know.
Sounds too easy.
Okay.
Along those lines.
All right. Somebody else. Who's the leader of this guild? I forget.
I think it's supposed to be Vork.
Well, then Vork,
I'll go talk to him.
Okay,
I want to go talk to him. Let's go find a farmer.
Go.
Okay.
Go.
I'm walking into the field right now.
So
there's a path.
He's probably in the house.
Where are you
through the crops?
Vork, what's that? The house.
Don't walk through his crops. Just walk to the house.
I'm going to walk to his house. I'll take a path. There's a small rocky path.
Through the crops.
Yeah.
Ask the DM where it is.
You can definitely avoid the ground dwelling crops. You don't have to be destructive if you don't want to.
No, I don't want to be. I'll just walk straight to the easiest way to get to the house without destroying.
Yep, and there's a bit of a path.
Okay.
You do see some extra like farm animals, definitely a dog here or there. Definitely you run across about 9 different cats running around this place.
Wow.
But as you approach I won't even make you roll for it. There's a commotion going on inside the house. It sounds it sounds like an all-out brawl. Things are falling over. Thump, 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 crash, crash, crash,
okay.
Bang, bang, bang.
Okay.
It's really unclear. It's definitely furniture and metal, wood. And then there are some like softer smacks that sound like people.
Oh, it's go time.
Okay.
Oh my God.
What was that? What was that?
Yeah, what?
I was cocking my crossbow. I have a crossbow. You gotta
a crossbow. I don't even use those instruments, and I've never seen that happen with a crossbow.
I installed the crank on mine, so you can.
It's just like we keep saying, you don't have to do the sound effect. We can hear it when you do it. Just just in the
outdoors. I wasn't sure. I just wanted to. I thought it would blend in.
Enhance it.
All right.
When I heal, do I go whoa? No, I
you
did
could,
that.
And I wouldn't make fun of you for that.
Totally I don't go cha-ching.
Right.
No, can I announce?
Okay, what are we gonna do here?
Can I announce my presence?
You can do that.
Yes.
Are we all like kind of waiting in the back? Like,
no, I'm not looking for a brawl. I just
if you want to be following Vork, Vork's in the.
We're following.
Okay. Yeah, hell yeah.
When he hears it, he's probably about, I would say, 20 yards away. It's pretty loud.
Blades, do you want to sneak around the back, like to
peek through
windows
rogue.
Or something?
Yeah,
no, that's fine. I just want to go straight on.
No,
I'm sorry.
I think okay. We should do like a little bit of like a surprise kind of deal. If Vork, if you walked up in the front and got their attention, and I snuck around the back, we could like, you know, come at him from two angles.
That's what I'm saying. Just in case shit's happening, why don't me Blades. And Blades?
But isn't it more suspicious if we're like sneaking around in the back? Like
they won't
just...
see me. Blades? Oh no, I'm like the knight.
Someone's being murdered in there, it sounds like. I don't know what's happening in there, but we should get in there to save somebody. Zabu,
why don't you check it out?
Zabu, let's go. Let's do it.
Okay. So Blades and I are going to go sneak around back. Blades and I are going to go sneak around back while they go to the front.
Yes.
Awesome.
Like, look through the window and see and make sure that everything's cool.
Okay, we'll do the thieves first. Roll a quick stealth check. Both of you.
Okay, 18.
Stealth check.
Yeah, it'll be a skill in
yep,
the...
got it. Hold on.
I'm very sneaky.
Nice. 18.
17.
All right.
Nice. Yes.
Wow, you guys. Good job.
Yeah. And as they approach, you can see that this is a nice white house with a roof. The bottom floor is bigger than the top floor, but it does look pretty spacious. It's unclear how many rooms there are, but there's smoke coming out of the chimney and then there is a second floor that looks about half the size. And then it does, as you guys sneak around, you can see that there is sort of a version of a backyard as well. And you can see windows on each side of the house.
Okay.
Can we look into the windows and see what the commotion is?
Yes. Cool. Which, from the back of the house, you want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wherever the commotion is coming.
Yeah, wherever we can hear it.
Okay. As you move closer, it sounds like it's happening kind of in the center of the bottom of the house, of the first floor. As you get closer and you are able to peek in, the curtains are drawn, but that doesn't mean you can't see movement. It's happening. It's one big space. And this is happening in the middle. You can now start hearing a man saying, stop it, please, stop it. Somebody help.
Oh God.
Do we have like a code? For danger.
Ah!
What was that?
I think our code was there's danger in there.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Okay. You two also hear a metallic voice saying, "Why would you do this to me? I wanted friends."
He's got like a
voice.
An animatron thing.
Yeah. Okay, so
that's revolting against
him. Now the other four of you, you're not trying to be quiet at all, so you're able to approach the house however you want.
Can I do an investigation?
Investigation, sure. What are you investigating?
I want to try and see if I can go closer to maybe the door to see what the front door shows.
Yeah, okay, so you're on the porch. There's a rocking chair. You're investigating. Right. Roll an investigation check.
Okay. What do I have, plus one? 14.
Okay. Far as what's going on right now, you can tell there's a fight going on inside, but there is another thing that you find right off of the front porch. It's like, going to try to explain this not being in front of you, but I am facing the house. There's a porch right here. There's a railing, and off the side of the porch, you were kind of walking around and just, you know, getting like setting the stakes and trying to figure out what's going on. So you look over the banister to see if there's anything there, and you actually see at this point you see a compost pile that looks that looks about 2 feet high. It's relatively big.
Okay.
But other than that, it's the main thing that's happening is commotion inside.
Can we hear the can we hear people? Now we're all kind of on the porch at this point.
Yeah.
Can we hear the screaming?
Oh, can I listen? I have a high perception thing.
You have a high passive perception?
Get in there.
Yeah, get in there. Let's get in there.
Yeah.
You guys can definitely hear the same thing. It's like a metallic voice going, "Will you be my friend? Will you be my friend?" And then kind of changing tone, like, "Why would you not give me friends?"
Let's get in there, Vork. We gotta get in there.
Yes, let's break
in. Go inside.
Go in. Get in.
I know. I'm going
you
in.
Go first. Okay. Go. All right. Vork's going in. At this point, I want everyone to roll initiative. Vork, you'll get to move at the very beginning of the turn before you'll get to kind of lay of the land and kind of make an attack or do whatever you want before the round starts.
But I rolled a nat 20.
Initiative Dang. Is 20-sided. Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. A d20. Or rolled you can click on the initiative on the D&D Beyond thing.
15.
Hey, are Blades and I still 11. In the back of the house?
Yes, you are.
Okay.
Is that nine?
You can see your friends kind of making a move, though.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I know what I'm doing.
Did anyone get a 20 or higher?
23.
Blades, okay. Anyone get 15 to 19?
15.
Okay, Tink and... okay, and did anyone get a 12 to 15?
I got a 14.
Okay, Clara. And then... 10 to 12?
I got 10.
Okay. And then
Jeff?
5 to 10?
I got an 8.
I got a 5. I'm just going to go.
I think my brother was staying.
I got this, buddy.
You're holding back. You're holding back to know what everybody else is doing. It's smart. It's a smart strategy, Zappu.
Yes. And remember, at any moment, you guys, I don't think I've ever told you this before, but you can hold your action and wait for a trigger for you to move. So if you want to wait for someone to like grapple or do something before you attack, you can always hold and go later in the order. But that's just for some knowledge. Okay. So at the beginning, Jeff, you open the farm door, the front door of the house, without any... you're not trying to be coy at all. You just burst in with your great sword and you take a look at the place. This is what you see. You see what looks like a knight in shining armor walking around doing this with their hands. This is where the voice is coming from. You also see this like table that's on four legs, but it seems to be moving and using one of its legs to try to attack this man who keeps cowering and trying to cower behind different pieces of furniture. On top of that, you see the rug in the living room kind of come to life. Oh, and as the guy's trying to dodge and use different things to throw these things, the rug is trying to smother the guy and like cover up the guy.
Okay.
And meanwhile, the animated armor is like it just looks like it's looking around and looks hopeless, like it keeps shrugging its shoulders like that.
My God. So there's a table, a carpet, and a knight in shining armor attacking a dude.
Man.
Okay.
Well.
Yeah, the table and the rug are attacking. The animated armor looks hopeless and shruggy guy.
Shruggy.
So the most dangerous thing right now is the rug that's trying to suffocate him.
Both the table and the rug look like, I mean, he looks terrified. And as you enter, he goes, oh, thank God, Aaron, please help me, please.
Give him help, Vork.
I'll attack the rug and the table.
Oh, wait, who goes first?
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, Vork, you get to do something first before the order starts.
Okay. Now, can I use my crossbow to shoot the rug?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. I can't shoot both of the same, both the rug and the table, could I?
Unfortunately, no. One target.
Okay, I'll shoot the crossbow into the rug.
Okay. Roll a d20 to see if you hit.
Okay. Cross your fingers.
Make sure to add your hit modifier.
Hit modifier. The hit. Okay, 19, 23.
Oh, dang. Yes.
Oh,
that
damn.
For sure.
I think you did hit them both.
Yes, that for sure, bing, bing. For sure hits. So your crossbow fires forward. It kind of gets the rug right in its bare threads, and the threads kind of move out of the way, they are moved out of the way by your bolt. So now I want you to roll damage, and crossbow... should be on your thing, but let's say...
Oh, damage. I see a 10 die. Yes. 10.
A d10? Yeah, d10 plus 2.
Wait, where's d10? Ooh. Shoot, hold on a second, guys. 10.
Is there any way that 23, like, pinned the rug onto the table?
Oh, man.
That'd be a hell of a shot.
If it were a natural 20 for sure, but I think that was an 18.
Is this the 10 die is like the 5 on, wait, two, yes, here we are.
You can also click the damage button on D&D Beyond if it's easier for you.
I'll do this. I think I know it. Okay, so 10, 4, plus one die, one 10-sided die plus 2. Mm-hmm. So 6, is that what it is?
If it's 4 plus 2 is 6, and that'll...
Confirm.
We got there.
I gotta do a perception check to see if that's true.
Insight.
Is that true? It is true. We are in a magical fantasy world.
I just want to make sure 4 plus 2 is...
Never be sure.
It's a true 10 miles. So your bolt does move through it with, I mean, this is kind of a classic Vork move. I mean, he looks like he's just in his head all the time, counting numbers, figuring out how much things cost. But when it's time for action, the door just slams open. The farmer says, please help. We zoom in really quickly to his face, and he just, and the crossbow itself comes into frame right at the bottom.
Wow.
And the crossbow just shoots its bolt right through the rug.
Sam Raimi directing this?
Trying to cover the man, just rears up, if that's a good way to describe a rug. And the bullet pierces right in the corner, but in a really hopeful place, and that's that corner of the rug kind of folds down.
Right in the rug kidney.
Wow.
You did a great.
I know how to kill a rug, guys.
Good job.
You know how to cut a rug.
He trained at that.
Catch a rug.
I shoot Zabu.
Okay.
Yeah, come on.
Blades. Yeah, you're up. You
all right, great. So Zabu, we hear all this commotion going on, right? Absolutely. Like Vork busting in?
You do see Vork busting in. Mm-hmm.
All right, great. So I turn to Zabu and I just say, all right, buddy, it's go time. But this time I only make the noise with my mouth. I'm not doing anything with the crossbow.
Oh my God, come on, man. All right, fine, let's go.
I stand up and I want to use the butt of the crossbow, and I'm going to break the window in and stick it in there.
Can you just come through the front door?
No. Well, he's
in the back. I guess I didn't tell you this, but I like this better anyway. There is a back door.
No. No.
Claire goes and runs and opens the door.
But on the side.
I take a moment. I look at the back door, which is about 3 inches from the window. No. Right in there.
Totally. What are you?
Well, so who from this angle? Who do I see? Table, rug. Who's most obvious?
I would say from the back. Yeah, I would say the rug was kind of going in from the front, so the table was towards the back.
All right, so I just want to take a shot right at the table.
Okay, the trying to splinter that table.
Yes.
Oh, and it's another crossbow.
Yep, it's a light crossbow.
We just
don't care that these are sentient beings. All right, roll to hit.
Now, would you say that an ally is within 5 feet?
Not yet.
Okay.
Because Vork, did a ranged
attack. Yeah, he's still coming at it. That was a 15 to hit.
Okay, yeah, that hits.
Hell yeah. And damage on that is going
do
to
the sound of...
I'm making all these noises in my mouth.
It's like, doesn't even sound powerful. Blades, come on.
I'm learning, okay? This is my second quest.
Good.
That was 11 damage.
11 damage, nice. Okay.
And then I have a bonus action too.
Okay, what's your bonus action?
Oh my. I'm going to use my bonus action to call out to the rug. Like, hey, you threadbare idiot. And distract it to give Clara advantage on her attack.
Okay, awesome.
So I'm using the help action as a bonus action.
So on your turn, you just saw your buddy Vork do like a really cool sniper shot at the rug. You, in a fit of can't wait any longer, you want to destroy something, you break a window. Zabu looks at the doorknob and just shrugs at you, and your crossbow flies through the window and you shoot. It's a huge target. I mean, it's a big table with four legs.
Hard to miss.
Four legs.
Wooden legs. So it is good you hit it. You would think that the crossbow bolt also being made out of wood or at least some metal might bounce off of it, but nah. This sticks in and almost hammers home and splits the wood, almost separating the back two legs from it. This table is not doing great. And then you also say what you say to the rug, and the rug, who's like slumped over a little bit, turns its attention behind it, or I guess in front of it. Yeah, you're coming from the back, so it kind of leans over and sees who's making this commotion, and it's you, Tink. You're up.
Longbow, please.
Longbow, cool. Lots of ranged attacks.
Longbow, please.
So now Bork is right in the doorway at the
Bork, move.
You can move. You can kind of slide. Yeah, you can slide by him. You wouldn't really be able to push him aside unless you want to.
Can I just yell at him to move or duck or something?
Yeah.
Duck, Bork.
Bork, do you do that?
Yes, I do.
Okay, cool. So he takes a knee. You're gonna long.
Should do an athletics check on that.
actually, wait. Am I? How far am I? Am I like 20? Well, like where?
The room. The room is like a 20 by 30 foot room. It's pretty. It's big, but it's also kind of tight. It'll start getting tight with everybody in there, especially if furniture starts attacking. So it's 20 by 30 feet. What was your question?
No, longbow's great.
Longbow will be effective, especially because you're shooting from outside. So you're going to be trying to hit what?
How is the rug doing? Is it alive or?
Yeah, rug and table are both still alive, but have taken pretty dire hits.
Yeah.
I'd like to just keep hitting the rug that's against the wall. Maybe just, pin it.
Get his other rug kidney.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So yeah, please make a d20 roll to see if you hit the rug.
A lot of interior decorating damage.
26.
Wait, 20. Was that a natural 20?
No, 19 plus 7.
Okay, awesome.
Damn.
Amazing. Oh, wow. You definitely hit. And it's a bonus action if you want to remember your hunter's mark, if you want to mark the table.
Yes, I will. That's a spell, right? Cast that?
Yeah, it's just a bonus action. So you're it's a bit of a spell, I guess. It is, but you can only do it three times a day.
Okay, so then I'll
That means if you hit, and you did, you get to do an extra d6 damage.
Beautiful.
Let's make some hand towels.
So roll damage for your longbow.
She still smells like vomit, but she's a badass today.
It's true.
Oh, fuck me in the ass. Four.
Wow. Children.
Wow, four. She's intense.
For the kids.
For the kids.
Four total? Is it four kids today?
It's always good to ask afterwards.
That's enough for
It's always a little bit for the kids.
Yeah, can I roll again? Can I roll again? Since
no, you can't. You can't do that. But you do. You do get to. So you did. You roll a 1 on your d8.
Yeah.
Okay. So you also get to roll a d6 because you marked it. So it's a 4 plus whatever.
Cool. Okay.
Not as bad as you thought.
Okay.
My son is asking what that means. Yeah, I need an answer.
He's never heard the F word.
Please.
Okay, so 7 total.
Come on.
Okay, I'll say that. So you get up behind Vork. Tell him to duck. He kind of does.
Vork, duck.
Yep. You pull back your arrow and let it fly. You kind of mark the rug and it does fly, but Vork he's not very sturdy on one knee. His bones don't work as well as you think they do. And he kind of jostles you. So you wind up not striking all that true, but you still rip through the rug. It just kind of rips through right where Vork shot him in the first
Vork,
place.
Vork, stop being so old.
I think Vork is young.
Clara,
it was your fault.
She just has a hard time kneeling. That's
Vork
all.
Is a vital young man.
It's a bad knee.
I had a hip replacement. Come on, guys.
Clara, your turn.
Okay.
And remember, Clara, if you attack the rug, you do have advantage on the attack because of my help action.
But isn't the rug's like against the wall, right? not doing anything, like being?
No, the rug kind of reared back a little. It's not out of range from the man. Like, it still could move towards the man, but yeah, it got blown back a little bit by the two arrows in the bolt.
Okay. Well, I have a. I have a chromatic orb.
Yes, you do.
Oh. And it's got. Well, if I go for the rug, mm-hmm. can I can I set that's it on fire?
Yeah. Oh,
that's but then good. We're in the house though. But
we're in a house.
go for it. Do it.
So you want to do, because a chromatic orb, you get to choose your damage type. You want to do fire damage to it?
I think so. I think that'd be really neato. Don't you? I think that'd be fun.
Yeah. I also like that Clara's like, I don't know, maybe this.
Yeah.
And shoots out a chromatic orb. So yeah, this will be you've already used a second level spell slot, so you have four first level spell slots, but you could cast this as a second level spell too.
This is a second level. I mean, I guess
you could cast it as a first or a second level spell. The second level spell means that it would just do more damage, but let me know.
I mean, I'll just save those. Let's do like the first level.
First level, okay? Perfect. Okay. Yeah. So this you
a little bit of arson.
Make a ranged spell attack. So arson. Again, just roll a d20 and add your spell attack bonus.
Roll two d20 because thank the you. Advantage. Thank you, Blades. Yes. Yeah.
Oh wait, I'm gonna do that. Okay. Hold on one sec.
Sandeep's in darkness.
Why'd you go back there and keep the lights off? Why did you do that?
I was trying to turn the fan on.
Oh, and then
on.
I add my
top here.
Spell but it looked.
I don't have a man slave bringing me pizza.
It's under spells. There's only my numbers at the top.
Yes. 46.
Ooh.
Second.
What?
What?
Is that bad?
Is he 46?
Yeah. Is it?
Could you clarify what you rolled?
Did you roll 220s?
You told me that somebody told me to roll 220.
Oh, yeah, but you just picked the higher one.
Sorry, you picked the higher one.
Hey, 46 is higher than the other one.
I like the 46.
46 is a hell of a roll. Okay, although it's a bit less than 100, so pick on that.
This is totally fun, you guys. I'm having so much fun.
This is awesome.
You're adorable. Nobody told you that.
Okay,
nobody 17. Told you that.
It's 17 then. 17.
17. Okay, that does hit. That does hit.
Great.
So now for chromatic orb, I think it's 3d8. So now you're gonna be rolling a few more dice too. So 3d8. And that's just 1d8 three times and add them together.
But I can do that on that little thing.
Yeah, you can. In the bottom left of D&D Beyond.
Okay. One moment, please.
All good.
This has to be a running thing now on this show. Just once an episode.
D8, what'd you get? 100.
I got 13. And then
13.
13 is a viable number. I will accept that number. Also, now roll a d20. This is going to be your wild magic.
Oh boy.
Okay.
I want it to be a one so bad.
It's another 9.
Okay. Another 9. Okay, great. So, no wild magic. Everything's within your control. You did 13 damage to the rug. It's still up. But okay, so here's what happens. Being a halfling, you're able to nimbly kind of jump over Vork's knee, slide past Tink, and you're in the room and you're able to get a good view, and you're just kind of thinking like, what would hurt this rug the most? Got it, it's fire. Whoosh. And you let it fly from your hands, and it's like half the size of a bowling ball, but it's a huge force of energy. And you get the rug right in its middle, and it's kind of like a Persian rug, which like red with some beige designs on it. Not anymore. This rug is black. The fringes are gone. It's like gonna be harder for the rug to grab onto anyone, including the man. And it's just like this flat piece of black scorched fabric. That's how
the whole new world for you
left it, and it's got two holes in it, and it is singed. It looks worse than fungus does on his on his death pile. Now
it's gonna be
the man looks at you and goes, "Oh, thank you," and he tries to stand up and get away. As he tries to get away, the rug is able to make an opportunity attack.
Uh-oh. The rug? I thought the rug is just char now.
I feel like the man, the bad guy.
It is, but we'll see. Yeah,
the reversal. Yeah, he really.
Did we mess up, you guys?
He spilled so much barbecue on that rug, and they were just like, "I'm done."
There's enough.
Okay, so the rug. The man gets up and tries to run away. The rug tries to smother him one more time, and just goes, and doesn't quite make it. In fact, a few more charred pieces of the rug threads kind of fly away.
Badass rug, though.
Can this rug be returned?
The animated armor that you haven't really paid much attention to just kind of shrugs and kind of looks panicked and goes, my friends are dying. I need more friends. And he walks over to the stove and taps on and kind of puts his hands right on the stove. For any of you, this is a wood-burning stove. It would be really hot, but he kind of rests his hands on it. And you kind of see the stove shake and vibrate and shift and just come to life. And it's it's on kind of 4 feet, and it kind of gets situated and I don't know, just hunkers down a little.
I have a huge fear of living stoves, you guys.
We're in Beauty and the Beast, guys.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
All the way to the back door, but the nine shining armor guy walks towards the back door. He's not quite there, but you can see him heading towards the back door. He says, "I need more friends."
Oh no.
He said what?
I need more friends. Now, now the rug's gonna, let's see, first the table's going to.
Hey, Amy, wait, is that a good dun 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 moment to stop at 8:30 and take a pee break?
Oh, dang, yeah, I got lost.
Yes,
thank you so much.
Okay, so we're going to take a quick intermission, you guys. I just want to give a shout out to our sponsor, XSplit. If you don't know what XSplit is, it is a piece of software that makes it super easy for you to just start streaming Twitch or whatever you want to do, live streaming. I started using it 5 years ago because it really just was the easiest way for me to get into streaming. From all of that, all the Geek & Sundry stuff started, so... it has been my companion for many years, and they are very kindly sponsoring this 4-episode D&D with the guild. So if you guys click on thank you, XSplit. So below our window, there is a 10% off code with the guild. And during our intermission, my mods are going to be giving away free 1-month codes. So just follow their instructions to qualify for that. And we will be back after we urinate.
Woo!
Attention RPG players.
Listen carefully. Are you or a loved one suffering from disabling physical and or mental conditions? If so, you could have been born with low roll syndrome, a serious condition. If low character attributes are present at birth, LRS may be to blame, and you or your loved ones may be entitled to a large and substantial re-roll compensation. Call the law offices of J. Michael Adler. Hello, I'm J. Michael Adler, and I've been helping people re-roll their attributes for over 2 weeks. Look, when you roll a low number, it's not your fault. If you or your loved ones have experienced these debilitating symptoms, low strength, truncated constitution, below average intelligence, underdeveloped charisma, stunted wisdom, or even death, I can help. I'm J. Michael Adler. I can't overstate it. I'm J. Michael Adler, and I can help you get the reroll you deserve. Let's roll.
All right, we're back. Thanks for bearing with us. Where we last left off, a battle ensued, and now a battle is still ensuing. So the armor just touched a stove, which came to life. And the rug is going to attack its biggest threat, which looks like, how far away? You had to come into the house a little bit. I'm going to say it can reach you. It turns around, Clara, and it comes at you It's going to try, it's going to rear up again and try to wrap around and smother you. Does a 22 hit? I think it
is. Oh my God. This rug is the blonde guy in Die Hard.
This rug is the worst.
Yeah. Okay. So you. Oh my gosh. Okay, cool. So yeah, you are definitely grappled, which means you can't move, and you begin suffocating. So you're also putting in some of its ash. You will have a chance on your turn to escape, but you can feel that its charred cloth is going to eventually start harming you if you don't get it off you.
My goodness.
The rest of you can see that too.
Claire, are you like, it's hugging me?
Yeah, first I think we're
it's a thunder jacket. Okay. The table.
I won't bark.
The table turns around as well, lets the man alone, and looks at the guy who shot him, which is blades through the
window. Fucking bring it!
And he's gonna charge at you.
Yeah, come on.
So he's going.
So wait a second. Did they all get turns before me?
Yeah, the monster rolled higher than you.
Oh, I see.
You were the five, remember?
Yeah. Oh, right. It's these guys, then Codex, then Gort, then Zabu.
Got it. Okay. Oh, and then you still go, Felicia, right?
I haven't gone yet. All right.
Does a 14 hit?
Me. Wait.
Yes.
It does not.
Ooh, it doesn't. Okay, great. So he, I think he just misses, man. I think he just misses. Okay, so he's kind of charging and he lifts up his leg and he's really trying to hit you, but you are, you're really good at moving your neck. Like
I'm all neck. Yeah,
your dance moves are real good. And so his leg comes up, he charges and you kind of fake him out and the leg just kind of goes right over your shoulder. You can see it right here. It comes back and your head pops back. He just kind of misses. Now the stove.
Doing the sound effects, huh?
Still doing it. Everything, every time I move. Yeah, I'm doing this.
The armor has moved towards the door and the stove has come to life and it kind of moves to the center of the room, faces Vork, Clara, and Tink. And just kind of vomits, like just goes
again.
The stove hasn't done anything yet. This is the first.
I know, but I got puked on again.
Oh, puked again.
It's clearly your lot in life.
Not a good day for Tinker
but
Bala.
It's not the vomit that you're used to. This is fiery things. And all three of you, Vork, Clara, and Tink, in a 15-foot cone. Each one of you needs to make a dexterity saving throw. So that's at the top. Man,
dexterity. One in the back, Blades.
Dexterity saving.
I'm glad we're here, man. This is great. Okay.
And that's a 20-sided? Yeah.
I think we should go after the armor.
Add, add your
stop shooting the fucking dexterity. Rug.
I got 14.
Oh, my God. I got
you
5.
You might have to save Clara, but I don't know. We'll see how it plays out.
5. She's in the rug, though.
I know.
Clara, what did you get?
I got 14.
14. And then, sorry, Tink, you got 14 as well?
13.
13? Okay, great. So you two are able to avoid most of the damage. Vork, you're getting it full on. Vork, you take 32 points of damage.
What?
Yeah, it's fire. I mean, these are hot coals being...
Wait, is he dead?
I think he's dead.
He's dead.
And then Clara and
wait, you can die?
You each take 16 points of damage.
You can die?
Oh no.
You guys get 16 points of damage?
Wait, I get 16 points?
Yeah.
Am I done for the rest of this whole thing?
You're unconscious technically.
Are you dead?
Yeah,
how many hit points did you have?
You're at 0 hit points.
We can get you back up.
Okay, all right. You better.
Yeah. You're officially not dead. It's actually very difficult for a player character to die in fifth edition.
We just all have to do mouth to mouth on you.
Okay, I can stabilize you. I can stabilize. And he has 4 turns, right, to be stable, to lose like
saving
throws. It
depends how he rolls.
Yeah, but he's got a few chances to not die. So
okay. Wow, Zabu, we really lucked out being back here, man.
Yeah,
it's not
that's
bad.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't like outside.
And that's the end of that. So now Codex, your turn.
Okay, so if I cast a heal on Vork, he immediately has, does he go to zero? Or does he, he'll go up to whatever he has, right?
Yep, that's right.
Okay, so I was going to save Clara's life, but I'm busy now because we have honey super wounded.
So hugging this rug.
I'm going to move to him and do a healing word second level.
Okay.
I'm going to do a second level healing word, and that will be, let's see. I'm going to keep track of my slots, and I'm going to roll, and that would be an 8. So 8 points of healing. Oh, is that plus 2 though? Oh, no, it's plus 3, which I already have. Okay, so I do that, and then
so how many points does he heal?
8.
8. Okay.
Okay.
So should I put? I'm at what 8? So I'm at 8. I went from 0.
Yeah, you're at 8 points total now.
Okay.
Oh wait.
And, can y'all three update your D&D Beyond?
Yes, I did. Whenever you use a spell of first level or higher to restore hit points, the creature regains additional hit points equal to 2 plus the spell's level, which was 2. So another 4. So you get 12, Vork.
12?
You get 12 total hit points. So okay. You go from 0 to 12. Okay, so then that's it. Now, can I make an Arcana a check as a free action, or would that be an action?
What do you want to know?
I just want to know if I recognize the magic that this creature's using.
The magic this creature's using, this is okay. You can tell that this is some version of a which creature, the rug or
the person who's bringing all these things to life,
the robot.
Oh, the suit of armor. You can tell the suit of armor itself is magical, and that it came into being through it's unclear how it came into being. You wouldn't really know the history of it, mm-hmm. but you can tell that the armor itself, the entire thing is magical. There honestly might not be anyone inside of it. It is just operating
and
on its own.
When it touched the stove, it was by touch that he brought it to life, or was there word that he spoke? Okay.
Yeah.
So I can't do anything about that, but I can use my bonus action to use spiritual weapon. Mm-hmm. And can I safely attack the rug and not hurt Clara inside?
Yeah, because the rug is on the outside.
Okay.
And I think, give me one second, because I don't know that a bonus action, I don't think you can cast 2 spells in one turn.
Well, I have a bonus action as spiritual weapon. So as a bonus action, can I not do it? Is that an action?
I don't think you can cast, even if it's a bonus action, I think in one turn, you can only cast 1 spell.
Correct, unless the other spell is a cantrip.
So if I attacked with a crossbow and then I could use spiritual weapon. So I can't use spiritual weapon and another spell.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you. Okay, well then that's the end of my turn.
Okay, cool. And you can relay that message to everybody. Vork, it's your turn again. You're back up.
So the table, there's still, everything's still up and running.
Everything's still up and running.
Hold on, what was the message that was relayed to all of us?
You go.
No, go ahead, Felicia.
No, it was, guys, the suit of armor is magical. There might not even be anybody inside it. And he's bringing things to life by touch.
Noted!
Why did you smash this person's window? My God, there's a door right there.
It looked thing.
Really cool!
Jesus.
So it feels like I should go to the source, the armored person to stop him.
Is that the source? That's
or
my question.
Or you can help me. I mean, go with what you feel, though.
Is it possible? Are they close enough that I could use a two-hand weapons?
Let me see. You could move. You could move to the animated armor and get in melee with it. Yeah.
He's still flying.
But shouldn't we try to kill the armored guy that's controlling all this?
What? He's an innocent civilian.
No, the armored.
The armored guy. Yeah.
Vork, you can do whatever you want, buddy. Follow your heart, man.
Can we ask the guy what's going on? Oh, sorry, you do your thing.
No,
I'll wait for my turn.
Wait, did Dabu have a turn?
He's last.
I'm after.
So he's last. He's after Vork.
Oh.
Can I attack?
Vork had a first opening move.
Can I do an attack? Can I attack the armored guy? Is he close enough to do a two-handed attack?
Sure. You would run up to him because he's towards the back door, and you would be able to attack him for sure.
Okay. So it would be my hand axe and my great... Oh, no. Two hand axes? I'm trying to think.
I can do two hand axes or your great sword.
I guess two...
Clara, we got you. Don't worry about it.
I feel good about
it. I'm trying. I guess with a great sword and a hand axe, I guess.
You can only do two hand axes or one great sword.
Okay, so two hand axes, yes.
Okay, so roll to hit with your hand axes. Roll a d20 twice.
Okay. A 9.
Okay.
Okay, and then.
Are you adding 5 to that?
Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. Wait. 9. Yes. So 14. And then this came up 12.
Okay. And you add 5 to that?
Oh, so 26, is that just do it together?
No, sorry. Sorry, the one D20, both D20s you add 5 to. So you got a 9 on one and that turns into a 14.
Right.
And then you got a 12 on the other and that turns into a...
12. I got a 7 on the other.
I see. Okay. You run up to the armored guy and you try to hit with both hand axes. He dodges both of them, actually. He like
Damn.
Like, wow. Out of the way, does some ninja quick moves and then re-stands up.
He's so wily for a suit of armor.
He's nimble. He's nimble.
The live one. Yeah.
Okay.
Neither of those hit Vork, but you were right in the thick of it now in the middle. Zabu, it is your turn now.
Should we just go get the pitchforks and...
Listen, I used that second level spell to very good use.
Should we just get out of here?
Can I talk to the guy that was like fleeing?
Yeah, I'll let you say like, a couple of things back and forth.
Ah, she's fine.
Great. Hey, is there a way to defeat the armor thing? Can we shut it off somehow? What's the...
No, it turned bad. It did chores for me. It was my servant, and then it just twisted. I don't know the magic that had it on there. It must be a trick from this traveling sorcerer that I got to enchant my suit of armor.
There's layers.
Okay,
there.
So we have to stop the armor, and that will stop the rest.
I imagine so. It turned on me. It began demanding friends, and then it started touching and caressing the rest of my furniture. And now touching. Look at us.
That seems inappropriate.
Caressing.
Yes.
Were you addicted to
perverse monsters?
Dickish guys.
Clara is smothering to death.
Clara, I'm getting hard to breathe.
She's fine.
Getting hard to breathe.
She has several rounds.
I mean, I got nothing to say for her.
But so he's yes, the source of the magic seems to be coming from him.
Zabu, okay. Gotta kill the
and
armor.
We know
buddy.
It's gender, it's definitely he. Okay, fine.
Well, he's wearing armor and there's no space for the womanly parts up in the
so it's like a cod piece. Makes it very clear.
Okay, Clara got it. Is smothering.
Zabu, attack it through the window. Do it through the window.
No, let's have a gender discussion about armor, please.
Dying here.
Really, feminine armor doesn't have to contain progress.
Can I
that's a good point. You want to join this discussion, man out the window?
I'm a big advocate of unisex armor, actually.
All right, listen. I'm sorry that I opened up the can of worms here. We can talk about this later. We'll hit the YouTube comments on this, and we'll talk about this. Look, I want to hex this mofo first. I'm going to use my bonus action first.
Okay.
If I can.
Yes, you sure can. So you hex him. Do great. I save against that, or do you just do it? I can't remember.
How would I know that? I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. Let me check. No, you just do it. It's hexed. You just say.
I just do it. I hex, and then I can deal 1d6 damage later, yeah. Right?
Uh-huh.
All right. I'm going to use Chill Touch.
Ooh, okay.
By the way,
I hope that my
Sandeep, what I want to do. When you cast Hex, you pick a attribute that you are harming, essentially. So strength, dex, con, whatever. And he, I think, gets disadvantage on those rolls going forward.
That's true.
Okay, so I think dexterity maybe is the thing to, because it was so slippery, yeah?
Sure, yeah.
Let's harm his dex. Let's hurt his dex. Let's hit him right in the dex.
Hex his dex.
Hex his dex.
We're going to hex that dex. And then For the kids.
Then, that made it worse.
Hex out with your jacks touch. Out.
And I'm hoping that the, because listen, my chill touch creates a ghostly skeletal hand and it clings to the target after it thing. So I'm hoping it'll hold it in place so it can't touch anything else and make that stuff come alive.
Amazing. Okay, great. So roll. I will, how about this? Because even though Vork did not do much on his turn, he definitely, distracted the armor. So Vork, I'm going to say that you can do the same thing that Blades did. And as a bonus action, you're distracting the animated armor. And maybe you didn't hit him on purpose. You were like, oh, where's this hand axe going to go?
Sure. Here? On is purpose. Here? Yeah. Oh,
and now Sandeep, you can roll with advantage on your chill touch, which you don't actually, you don't physically touch. So
correct.
Roll D20 twice, take the higher of the two and add your spell attack.
Okay, so 17 on my first one, and then, all right, 17, we're going with the 17.
17 total?
You said take the higher of the two, right?
Yeah,
and then add your spell.
Did you add spell your spell attack?
Spell attack.
I did, 17 total.
Okay.
Yeah, it's still, it doesn't quite hit.
What wow. is this thing?
Yeah.
Dude.
Come on. We are whiffing it.
Yeah, you're whiffing it. So the hand, so both of you, your blue hand that's very cold is kind of waving in its face. It meant to touch its face, but it didn't quite get there. And Vork is there kind of hacking and slashing at it, not quite hitting it either.
Wow.
We should have grouped up.
Yeah. Now it is Blades' turn again.
Okay. Here we go. It made no sound when I did that.
The one time you actually need a sound.
Yeah.
Crack. There we go. Cool. So right now, we have Vork just hacking and slashing at the armor. Clara is being strangled by carpet. And that's about it, right?
And you're
yeah, the table that. Tried to attack you and just missed.
I gotta just bounce them off you. So do I have the impression that if I were to attack the suit of armor, that he is sufficiently flanked and distracted that I might get advantage on that roll?
Yeah, you could just, you definitely get advantage and sneak. I would say sneak attack too.
Okay. I'm confident Clara has like, you know, about 30, 45 seconds left. So, you know, it'll be fine. I'm going to go for the suit of armor.
I took a deep breath.
Hey, if I can, yeah, there you go. If I can take out the suit of armor, our problems are solved.
All right. Well, fingers crossed for me.
So here we go. Yeah. I'm going to crossbow the suit of armor. Here we go. Oof. Okay. First roll, not so great. That was a 19 to hit.
Okay, that does hit.
Oh, hey, yes.
Yeah, what are you hitting
him for? Good for a 19.
Wow.
That's why they pay me the big bucks, baby. Oh. Yes.
No, we don't pay you anything. Please stop. Please pay me more. Yourself, please.
So what are you hitting him with?
So my crossbow right now, I broke some more of the glass. And then I want to get it line up a good shot there.
Okay.
And I want to try and get him like right in between. It. Like a couple of the notches in the armor, just like okay. What appears to be a weak spot.
Yeah, I would say maybe his gut.
Yes, right, yeah. Center mass. Hell yeah.
Center mass. Yeah. Sure. Okay, so how much damage do you do?
Okay, so my base damage is unimpressive. That's 5 base, but then I also roll my sneak attack damage, which is 2 more d6. So 5 plus. Plus 5. Okay, so I do 10 damage total.
Okay. All right. So
stop. Please never do that again.
Yeah.
So many things.
This is like Police Academy. I can't take it.
He's no longer facing you, so you do shoot him in the back. You kind of shoot him where, kind of on the side of the back, so where his kidney might be, and it sinks all the way in. Like you can no longer see your crossbow bolt. So
yes.
Whatever happened, it's like it's being jostled around. You can actually kind of hear it tinkering around inside of him, and it's kind of messing with the whole magic sentience of it all. So you kind of hear it. You kind of hear it. Bang and ding dong all the way down to its foot. So this, your crossbow bolt is now in the bottom of its boot.
Then I want to use a bonus action and I'll say, hey, Tink, give him hell. And I want to give Tink advantage on her roll if she attacks the suit of armor.
Ah, okay, great.
But I have to save Clara. What's wrong with
you? Somebody else will.
It's fine. We'll get around to it. I got it.
It's fine.
How am I the
one with the heart here?
Listen, I'm the healer. I'm supposed to save people. You just do what you want. You do what you need to do. Do what you need to do.
What are you going to save her with? Your longbow?
Love.
You got nothing. Don't mistake me. Your
great conversation.
I mean... It's
you
my
do
turn.
You do you, Tink. You do what
it's
you
my
want.
Turn?
Yeah.
Yes, it is your turn.
What did you give me, Blades?
I gave you advantage on your attack if you attack the suit of armor.
That means you get to roll the 20-sided dice and take the higher roll. So
okay,
you can make sure
Clara,
to hit it.
Clara, I love you. You're my favorite person here. But
hey,
what? I feel like if I kill this suit of armor, then the magic spell of the carpet might go away, therefore let you go.
Yes.
That is, do
good
it.
Good call.
All right, take,
You
just fuck
so
it.
So don't be mad at me, okay?
Just fuck it.
Just do it.
For the children, do it for the children.
Sorry. Do it. Okay.
For you, Clara. Okay, I'll longbow this fucking armor, I guess.
Okay,
for the children.
For the
children. Sorry. I'll do
my
this armor. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Literally, I'm so sorry. I will longbow this armor,
it's okay.
Man.
It's okay here.
Okay.
Jeff, I feel like your son could teach me some stuff, honestly.
I will roll.
I think that's true.
Yep, you roll a d20, but you roll it twice and take the higher of the two.
Okay. Got it. Let me write that down. That was not great. Wow. Things are not looking good for you, Clara.
Oh, no.
I rolled 11 both times.
Plus 7. Oh, it's an 18.
Oh gosh, darn it.
Wait, 11. But did you add? Did you add your?
I did.
Oh,
I rolled a 4 both times.
Oh my God.
We are.
Wait, should I do it again? Because I did it on the computer. Maybe I should do it on a real
time. No.
I think she should do it on a real dice.
Right,
I think so.
Right,
Vorpy?
Yeah. No,
I think that would be nice.
You rolled your roll.
You can do it
listen,
once
we're all
going to
die
die
in this room. We're going to die
in
this
room.
You can
do it once on the real die.
Oh, wow.
Don't
that's
make
a boom.
This a habit.
Okay, she's going to let you roll. Just really? Do it. She's going to let you roll.
But
real.
You don't
okay,
get
okay.
advantage. You don't
one
get
die.
Nice, what a nice lady.
One more roll.
I know. Such a nice.
It's going to be less,
nice
isn't it?
Is
it a 4?
She rolled a 1?
What is she...
Oh,
go
no.
With the
okay, never mind.
Go with the
we shouldn't have cheated anyway. We'll just go back. We shouldn't have cheated anyway.
The dice gods have spoken.
Yeah, okay. Karma's a bitch.
No. This is bad. Okay.
This is bad.
You.
When your DM
no,
says
no, I rolled an 11. Let's just say I did an 11.
Boy, I am just carrying the party here, man.
Okay, so you pull back your bow. You're still outside the house. And while... while you're talking to Clara and telling her she's your favorite person and everything, that's actually kind of when the arrow lets loose. So, Clara, the rug and you will both make a dexterity save. Make it kind of easy.
Oh.
11. So we both make it. If either one of us makes it, we are able to dodge out of the way. Otherwise, we take a d6 of damage.
Wait, but maybe I got the carpet.
That's what I was just saying.
Roll
the
you would get both of them. Otherwise, you get both.
Amy, I'm so glad you shot
roll
Clara.
Roll a d20. Roll a d20.
So wait, I rolled a d20.
Is there
okay.
any chance that it could hit the carpet but not
it.
Clara?
Robin, roll the D200.
I think it's going to skewer her right through.
It fell, but you're like very strong. You're able to.
It fell, but it's a 17.
The 17, great.
Wow.
Okay, so nobody takes any damage, not even the rug. But Amy's like, Clara, you're my favorite person. I really, I would save you, but I can't. Oops. And
I'm better than this, you guys. This is not what
the
happened.
Arrow flies in the rug and her favorite person, Clara. But Clara in a second of clarity actually goes, no, wait, and like jumps out of the way and lands on her side, and the rug is also protected by that. The rug does it does land some of its charcoal-y scorchness does fall off again as well. Okay, Clara, unfortunately at the beginning of your turn, while you're smothered, you take 2d6 plus 3 bludgeoning damage at the start of your turn. I rolled it already. It's 5 bludgeoning damage. How many hit points are you at now?
brother. I don't know.
Come on. Well, you took how much damage before?
16.
16.
I'm at 16. Yeah.
Okay. So you took five.
Okay.
Just now.
Yeah. So you had 11.
I have 11.
How many hit points do y'all have? I have 21.
I have
22.
No, Claire, 25. You have
21.
17. It said I had 17, right?
Yeah, but then
I had
16. So you had one hit point left.
Oh no! So you're down.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay, I'll get you, girl.
I'll get you, girl.
Okay.
Get you, girl.
I feel like Claire is always like suffering.
Lose an arm.
I know.
The arm. Yes.
Okay.
I forgot about that.
If it works.
Okay. The first thing that happens is the armor actually opens the back door and tries to move towards the field.
Bring it.
It moves pretty. It moves a full 25 feet out the door. The table is gonna go for blades again.
Now, Ms. Vorpal.
Yes.
Given where Vork is positioned, would he get an attack of opportunity on that suit of armor?
Yes, he would. Vork, as the armor moves away, you are holding hand axes, so only it lets you attack with one hand axe. But as it's moving away, you're able to engage with it one last time. Maybe not the chill touch. That's a range attack. But make an attack of opportunity with your hand axe.
Okay, that's 20 sided. That's
20 sided die.
Mm-hmm. Come on, baby.
Come on.
End this for us, man.
Eight.
We need this.
Oh my God, an eight.
Eight plus.
Yeah, we won first.
Plus
it
five.
It might not matter.
Oh, plus I'm sorry. Five. Yes, 14.
Okay, still not enough. Still not enough.
Plus 11.
13, sorry,
no,
13.
It's 18
okay, the table goes for blades. Once more, it tries to attack. 12 will not hit. Then the rug itself, it's kind of liking Clara at the, no, actually it realizes that, oh yeah. So it realizes it's kind of suffocated Clara and it kind of lets her go and pats her like it's putting her to sleep and then turns to someone else. It's going to turn towards
Tink
in the doorway.
What?
And Tink, you are going to, oh dang, okay, so a 9 will not hit, but it's right up in your face, okay? And then that says, okay, the stove, which was actually the scariest of all, it has to spend a turn, seeing if it recharges, does not recharge on that attack.
Really bad, huh?
But it can, it can join the rug in attacking you. It's going to, ooh, that 19, does a 19 hit? Tink.
Yeah.
Armor class, your armor class.
Obviously it hits, 19 is a very high number.
Oh my God.
Okay, so you take 8 damage as it's kind of stovetop pipe kind of swings at you and connects with your head, you take 8 damage.
Oh my God.
Oh,
you guys are just getting
I'm very close to dying. I just want to
by inanimate objects.
I was just gonna say we're dying by inanimate objects.
Kodak, no, it's like
you're the beast.
At IKEA or something.
Okay.
We get killed by IKEA.
So boy,
not the Swedish meatballs.
I would like to. I could stop this thing from going out. Can I see it? Is it close to me or is it within?
Yeah, it's just out the door. So it's 20, 25 feet out the door, which still is pretty much in distance. You could
I'm
run.
Probably going to try to keep it from going out that door.
I think we're also going to go after the armor.
I think, but it has another turn before Zabu. The knight, the armor?
No,
didn't
no.
It just take its turn?
And then Vork and then Zabu.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I should probably heal these people, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
What do you mean these people?
Okay, I'm going to use my Bertha, my holy symbol.
Yes.
And I'm going to channel divinity up to 15 hit points divided between any creatures within 30 feet up to half of an HP max. So I'm going to give Clara 10.
What?
And I'm going to give...
I'm at
Tink
one,
five.
Just so you know.
I'm giving Clara 10 and Tink 5.
I'm at one.
Okay, I'm giving Clara 7.
Clara's dead.
Clara's...
Oh, she is?
I'm at one as well.
Yeah, we're the same.
Okay, so each of you, one of you needs more. One, okay, listen, 15 doesn't divide evenly, all right? So one of you gets 8 and one of you gets 7.
I'll get 8.
Okay. Okay,
oh, Tegan. Like, wow. Come on.
What I felt like you loved me. I felt like I was your best friend, and you're just gonna take the 8. I
mean, well, you're my best friend out of these people, but like obviously I'm my
what
best
do you mean,
friend.
These people.
Tegan's only best friend is herself.
Oh my god! You're okay.
Wow, Zabu, the team's like breaking down, man.
Wait, so 8, right?
Okay, she gets 8. Fine. And okay. Clara gets 7 and an apology. Okay. She gets 7 and an apology.
All right.
But we're still, we're both alive. It's totally fine, Clara.
Okay, great.
I'm not going to talk to you for a second because
now, we're both fine.
Chose to take
we're question. Both alive. Life is great.
It. That's fine. That's
is channel
fine.
Divinity a spell or is it an ability? Because can I use my spirit weapon right now?
Yes, you can.
Because it's not really a spell. Okay, great.
An ability, yeah.
So I'm going to damage the carpet because I think, does it look really bad? Does it look within like?
Yeah, okay. It's on, yeah, bare.
It's not looking good. Okay, so I'm Red going to.
Scorched.
Oh, okay. I got ordered a 12 plus 5. So 17?
Cool, that hits.
Okay, and I'm going to roll a 1d8 plus 3. Ugh, okay, 5. I kill it. I do 5 damage.
Yes, you do. And you do actually, you do take it out. So describe what happens. You've got your hand slappy tool, right?
It's the hand slappy tool. Yeah.
The hand slappy tool. So what does it look like? Tool. I mean, this rug is like kind of standing up, you know, in a flat rectangular, but it is like faded and drooping and scorched and holes are in it. So what does the hand do to destroy it?
It takes one of the holes and then just gives it a rim, like around the rim. It just opens it up.
Is it a rim what?
Rim what?
Yeah, what would you call that?
It goes around the rim of like the hole.
It's doing a good job.
And it goes around and around and around.
Rim work. It's doing some.
It
good
says it's a good job duty. Doing a rim around the thing.
Yes. Okay. Cool. So
for the kids.
Around the world. Yeah. And as the hand does it, does that, the some threads kind of peel off on the hand, and it snowballs into finally the hand just has a whole bunch of the carpet, the rug wrapped around it, and the hand itself just looks like a big boxing glove now. And why not? That spiritual weapon hand can do an extra 2 damage.
Yes.
It's got a boxing glove wrapped around it.
Awesome. Oh wow, that's awesome. Okay.
Yeah. Vork.
Am I up?
Yeah, you're alive.
I see there's a second win. Once per short rest, I can use a bonus action to regain 10 die plus 3.
So yes, you can do that. It would be a bonus action. So you could do that. You could do an action on your turn and do a bonus action. Here's the thing. If you're holding a hand axe and another hand axe, one of those is your bonus action, I think.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So you could use your greatsword and attack, which would do similar damage. Damage as both of those hand axes and still heal yourself.
And the armor guy's right there, right?
He's right there. You could walk up to him, sure.
So I could do the great sword then.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do that. And then the bonus action can happen after that.
Yep.
Is that what you? Okay.
Yeah, it could happen before or after. It's up to you.
Okay. I'll do the great sword.
Okay.
Okay. Come on, guys.
Come on.
Come on.
10, 15.
15 does not hit. It does not hit the armor. It hit. It is armor. Like it is. It's some good steel plated armor all the way wrapped around it. So it hits, but it kind of just nicks it and bounces right
off.
Yeah, but you can still do your second win and gain some hit points back.
Okay, so and this is a different.
Hold on. Was it being distracted? Because it was just walking.
Yeah, away. Totally.
It was walking. Like
Vork, you can be the one to distract it this time.
Yeah. Okay, so I've done my job already. Also.
Yeah, sure. And then, yeah, yes, your second wind, if you want to roll a d10 plus 3,
okay.
You get those hit.
Okay.
And then, Zabu, you're up.
God, how many weak spots in this thing? All right.
You looking for a chink in the armor?
I am looking for a chink in the armor. Is there like a check I can do or no?
Yeah, I'll say, I mean, let's see.
What are the chances I'm going to roll a freaking 18?
Yeah, you would need an 18. So I'll say because It needs to get hit one more time because it's only been hit once. There is a crossbow bolt inside of it, messing with the sentience and the magic of it. But if it gets hit one more time, I'll give it a negative factor to its armor class.
You can do it, Zabu. You can do this.
Go for it. I believe in you, man.
I'm gonna try to Eldritch Blast it.
Nice.
Yes.
That's the move.
Mm-hmm. And is it still? I think it's still hex.
It is.
Yeah,
it is still hex. So if I get to, if I have to hit it to do more damage, right? With
yes,
hex, that's how it works.
And you get to roll with advantage because we're saying Vork is distracting it by not
distracting.
Okay,
Vork's doing a great job.
I'm doing nothing.
Right. Let's just go for it. What's that? Oh, a B is a natural 20. I didn't realize that.
Oh yeah.
Okay, great. I rolled this beyond.
Yes,
I believe.
This is about to hurt a lot.
Yay!
So I'm not even gonna re-roll. That's
your thing. Okay, so here's what happens. Critical. You got a critical hit. Yes. That means dice so nice you roll them twice. So for damage, you were gonna only roll one D10. Now you roll two D10 plus one. And on top of that, you get to roll another D6 for your hex.
Yes. Oh my god, this is exciting. Damn.
It's a game changer.
Yeah, depending on how much you roll, you might.
Thank you. You're almost impressing me right now.
It's ruined.
Are you feeling funny down there?
Not at all.
Plus 11, plus, and then you said a D6?
Not at all.
Yes, an extra D6 for the hex. Yes.
Wow, this could be very painful for him.
Possibly.
7 plus 11 plus. Oh, I'll just roll up. 4. So 22 damage.
Woo!
Kaboom!
Wow.
Whoa. Did you roll? You rolled really high on those D10s then, huh?
I rolled a 10 on one of them. So which was in a plus one. So I rolled a 7 and an 11. I rolled a 6 and a 10. So plus one on both of those. And then I rolled a 4 on my
D6.
Ooh.
On my hex.
You got 23 because it's one D10 plus one.
Yeah, that's what he did.
Yeah, I counted that.
This is what happens. You've had just about enough of this. Your friends keep dying and getting reborn by Codex.
That's my job.
Yeah, everything's kind of going nuts. The stove is belching. Things are on fire, and in un-Zabu like fashion, you finally focus on something that matters. And, and it is killing the thing that is killing your friends, not just Codex, but everybody. And you turn and you get the evilest.
I love all these guys.
You get the evilest warlock look on your face. It frightens everybody. Your eyebrows go full Dr. Strange up and down, and your forehead creases, and you just lift your hands up. You've hexed this creature. You've put a curse on him. Your packed patron, your packed patron inside your head is vibrating, and you just let loose at this thing.
So harsh.
Wrap around it. They actually wind up entangling it, and it trips. Arms fall off. The legs fall off. It is able to. It's still on its chest, and it uses its chin to keep crawling. But other than that, the armor. It looks like it went straight to. It may as well be paper, for what you did to it.
Oh,
nice!
Wow.
The grass itself, as it's crawling, seems to be doing damage to the armor.
Damn, Zabu!
The wrong gnome.
The wrong gnome for sure. I can't
wrong gnome. I pronounce the G.
Almost dead it is.
That's how tough you are.
Straight G gnome.
That was awesome. Okay, blades.
Hi. So, okay, so the other furniture is still alive as far as we can tell.
Yep.
And the suit of armor is in pieces, but the head is kind of just like.
Yeah, it's still alive as far as you can tell as well.
Time to curb that.
Okay, yeah, I want to run up to the head and draw my rapier and try and just drive it down into the ground.
Fantastic.
Great idea.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Where am I at? Well, that's an 11 to hit with the rapier.
Okay. Ooh.
Can I hit the head inching along the floor?
No, you actually do. And as thin as the metal is, it's still holding strong where it is. You underestimated how tough it was. Yeah, dink. Not quite there, no. But really, gosh.
Needed a better sound effect, buddy.
Roll.
Guys, I really thought that'd be it. I was really banking on that.
Dink, dink, dink. Oh, Tink's turn.
Oh. Am I close to this? Thing?
I would like to use a bonus action.
Wait.
Shut up, Blades.
It's my turn still.
Bonus action, Blades.
Yes, I'd like to use a bonus action, and you're welcome, Tink. I want to go over my shoulder and say, Tink, finish it off, and use the help action to give her advantage on her attack.
Fantastic. Okay, all right,
fine.
Wow, yeah, this guy's good.
Yeah.
Advantage on the suit of armor that should be dead, but still is.
It should definitely be dead by now.
Am I close to this armor?
How close do you want to be? Like, are you trying to shoot it?
Like
with
F and
the
I close.
You're not close, but you can't get closer. Are you trying to shoot it with an arrow, or what do you want to do?
I mean, I wish I was close just so I won't miss, but.
Oh, got funny. You. You can get within range for sure.
You're
okay.
A badass archer.
Okay. I'll just do the longbow. I don't have to be that close.
Curve it like wanted style.
Yeah, bend it like Beckham.
There you go.
Okay, whatever. I'll hit it. I'm going to hit it with the longbow.
Yes,
so I'll roll my dice, okay?
Love it.
Oh,
B! B!
Yeah, he rolled beyond. Oh, God. Okay,
27! 27!
Yes, just for fun. Dice so nice, you roll them twice. So,
God.
Roll a d8 twice. Add 3.
Wait. One step at a time, please.
Yes.
D8.
Roll a d8 twice and add them together.
Twice. Well, 11.
11, and then add 3.
14.
Perfect. Okay, that, and your mark was actually, well, it doesn't matter anymore. Sorry. When the rug died, you could have moved your hunter's mark to this one. So we'll just say you did it, and you did another d6 damage, too.
Ooh, do it again.
Yeah,
roll a
d6. Roll a d6.
Okay. 3.
14, so it's 17, is that right?
17.
So yes. 17 yes. Total, which means it has negative 16 hit points. It had one hit point.
God, Blades. Wait a whiffy.
I dinked. I should have donked.
Always
donked.
You know, you shouldn't have dinked. You should have tinked.
I should have tinked it.
Oh, nice. Nice.
So you did... If you want to describe what your arrow does to like obliterate this stupid armor helmet that was still alive, let me know what your arrow did.
I mean, I just shot it and it just went straight into his head.
Yeah.
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
and that's actually the center core of what was
like right here in his third eye.
Right in that chakra.
But it was crawling away from you, so it came from the back.
Oh yeah.
And
it just went
through.
That's cute. I like that.
It's cute. It's kind of cute. So he's down for the count. If a helmet could die, I guess it would just kind of tip over. And that's what it does. But you could tell that like some energy was going on in it that was making it sentient. The stove returns to a stasis point. The rug is the rug's wrapped around Felicia's hand weapon. And what else was alive? Oh,
and
the table.
Table.
And the pee.
Yeah, the table. The table's leg just and just creaks back down to the floor. So it looks like the threat is averted. Everyone just make Blades and Tink make a perception check. Blades, Tink, and Zabu make a perception check. The last three people who hit the suit of armor.
Uh-oh.
Thank you.
That's a hot 6 for me.
Okay.
10. It's a healthy 2.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
Tink, what did you get?
10.
A 10. Okay. Yeah, y'all think the Zabu and Blades look at it and are like, man, that thing sure died trying to get out to the field. And Tink, you just look out in the field and there's nothing really out there, except you do see some corn stalks and some berries, some apple trees, and a scarecrow sort of in the direction that the guy was crawling.
Ooh, she was gonna like do a little musical action on us. Good job, Tink. I'm glad I gave you that extra hit. It was really that extra hit point that put you over the top, right?
Yeah, aren't you glad you gave it to me?
I mean, we'll talk about it later.
Or the 22 damage I did, but whatever.
I mean, I softened him up too. I feel like we all kind of played a role there.
Great, collaborative effort. Okay?
I did a lot of distracting.
Yes. I did nothing.
Clara, you were a great burrito.
I enjoyed my...
Wait, where's the farmer?
Yeah, the farmer is huddled in a corner. But okay. He, as you are all patting yourselves on the back, he looks around and goes, "Oh, you all did a wonderful job. It's hard to pick favorites here."
But if you had to, like, who would you...
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
Oh, you're putting me on the spot.
Should I show you my chest?
Remember this thing?
Oh God!
Oh my gosh! I pick.
Air blades.
You.
Who? I don't know where you're pointing.
He points in the direction. He points in the direction of Tink and Vork. And it's unclear if he's picking Tink or Vork. But he's
sure it's me.
You.
I mean, obviously it's me. Why would it be Vork?
Look at him.
What? You people.
Oh.
It's the hair. It's always the hair.
But I mean, does it really matter?
Wait, does the scarecrow have a trident in its hand? Was that where I detected a pitchfork? Or was that the...
You detected...
I detected a pitchfork in a field and in a barn.
Yes.
Is the scarecrow holding a trident?
The scarecrow... No, it's not. No, it's...
Oh,
not.
Okay. Okay.
Sorry. No,
I was just going to make it easy for us. Okay, great.
Yeah.
Right, the clue said follow the origin.
Sir.
Oh, right? Okay.
Follow the origin.
Sir? Mr. Farmer?
Something.
Oh, you can call me Pilar.
Pilar?
Pilar.
We're on a quest, Pilar. We're looking for a trident. Have you seen a trident recently?
Wow, it's funny.
Like a really powerful one, right?
Yeah.
Also possibly like fleshy. I'm not sure. The name is ambiguous.
Fleshy?
Do you have anything to do with mushrooms, sir?
Well, these are a lot of questions.
We're not selling them.
Oh, that's interesting that you asked. No, nothing like that. I mean, if you're looking for a pitchfork, I have a couple of those. And I did get rid of, I had a magic pitchfork, but I got rid of it.
Wait a second.
Could you tell us what the origin means? This place is called Origin Organics. Is that named after something?
Oh, yeah. Why?
Yeah, I'm calling it Origin Organics. It's like, you think of it like, well, where does nature come from? You kind of want to, whatever you put in your body, you want it to mimic that of nature. So the apples from my orchard, they're fresh and organic. And where do they come from? The earth itself, the actual origin. It's just kind of a thing to let you know how healthy I'm being.
It's cute. Great. It's catchy.
Can we talk about how you got rid of that trident?
Yeah, it didn't work.
Oh, well, where did you get it? And where did it go, sir?
Well, yeah, you buckle up for this story. I got swindled. I got swindled. There was this traveling sorcerer who for a low, low rate said that they could help me in any part of my farm that I could want. And so I said, I wanted help with my compost pile, honestly, because to be honest, my crops were growing A+. Did not need help there. But the compost pile, it's just, takes so long to break down, you know, like for some months. So I said, can you enchant this pitchfork? And then when I use it on the compost pile, maybe it'll break down compost more. And really what it started doing was growing the compost pile to like a crazy amount. And it just kept growing and growing. And I guess
almost like tripling its lifespan, you could say.
What?
Yeah, maybe, but also, there was one day, I mean, I let it grow as much as I just wanted to see how long it would grow, you know, because I can use that stuff everywhere. And then one day it got really big. It was like, you know, 10 feet tall, 10 feet wide. And then the next day I woke up and it was gone. It was like it grew legs and walked off, but the pitchfork was still there.
It was interesting.
Like, yeah.
So wait, the compost pile walked off? Sorry, is it out?
That was about 6 months ago that I got the pitchfork from the
hundreds
sorcerer.
Of generations, guys.
It didn't work.
Okay.
It happened a few more times where I tried and it would grow. And then I guess I got greedy. I should have just stopped, but it just disappeared the next night. So this
guys, it didn't write you back or anything?
Wait, do you still have that pitchfork?
No, I gave it back. So
you gave it to who?
Who'd you give it back to? Yeah.
I gave it back to the gnome sorcerer who he runs around here every once in a while.
Oh, the traveling
is it the
salesman.
Guy that we fucked up from the last thing?
What?
No, sorry. Wait, no, that was an aside to my friend.
I'm so sorry for my friend's profanity.
I don't think it was. I don't think it was.
Okay,
different one.
So there's
the gnome's name is Yankle Tinkle.
Yankle Tinkle.
I mean, how do you pronounce that?
I remember that.
Spelling. Can you spell that?
Yankle Tinkle.
I have a cousin named Yankle Tinkle.
Common.
Kind of a jerk.
I think one of Vork's aunts is no. Okay.
No, my aunt is Yankle Tinkle.
I need like a little bit of a recap on that. So like, magic pitchfork poking a.
Compost pile
got up and walked away?
I don't know. All I know is I woke up one morning and the huge pile was gone. And there were some remnants. It did look like it was dragged or something.
So that's how we got to. That's what we got to follow.
Maybe no, that was the mushrooms.
No, guys, yeah, I think he created the mushroom people.
The mushroom people.
I didn't do anything. Yankle Tinkle did something.
Totally fine. Yeah, where can we find
Mr. Tinkle? Sorry.
Where can we find Tinkle Tinkle?
Yankle Tinkle.
That's racially insensitive.
What?
Yankle Tinkle.
I'm so sorry.
I am deeply offended.
It's Yankle Tinkle. Okay. I'm sorry. My mistake. Zabu, please, could you clarify the pronunciation for us? After all, you are a gnome.
Okay.
It's Yankle Tinkle.
And the surname?
Yankle
Tinkle.
So, well, anyway, he's an asshole.
Okay.
Okay.
Sure.
Well, wait, did he give you a refund?
Yes, he did. Kind of. I mean, now you saw what happened. So I gave him the pitchfork back. I said, I want nothing to do with it. You swindled me. And he said, sorry, he apologized. And he said, is there anything else you would have me do? And I said, honestly, it would be awesome if I had a servant, like a house help. So he enchanted my suit of armor that I got from a very happy customer, but it was just a suit of armor. He enchanted it and it was working for the last two months or so. And then all of a sudden, like all of Yankle Tinkle's bullshit, it turned on me and started complaining about not having friends, beating me, waking all of my other inanimate objects up and beating me. So you really came at a good time.
Honestly. Yeah, stop buying stuff from that guy.
No, I will. Yeah.
Do you know where he...
I'm so lazy.
Do you know where he is right now, Yankle Tinkle, Mr. Yankle? Tinkle?
I know. I know him from having come... to my farm.
Uh-huh.
But I think he's got a pawn shop in town, or else he does some tinkering up in the mountains.
Okay.
Wrinkle Tinkle does tinkering?
Tinkerer.
Are we far from
Yankle
the
Tinkle Tinkers? We all know that.
So
Yankle Tinkle Tinkers with Tinkle Bell.
How far is the town and how far is the mountain?
It's Mondopolis.
We've been there.
You're like halfway to the town. The mountains you've been heading north to the town, by the way. The mountains themselves, you would be going to the west. It'd be I guess he's about, I mean, he comes here often, so he's less than a day out. He's less than a day out.
Which direction was he going the last time you saw him?
Well, this was 2.5 weeks ago. He had the trident, so he would have gone back to town. All right, he had the pitchfork. He would have gone back to town.
Okay.
At least to pawn.
He can't go back to town? Okay. Well, you mean
not to
Mondopolis.
Not to Mondopolis. To a different town with a pawn store.
We have some nefarious people after us, and since we saved your life, I need to ask you, under no circumstance tell them any information. Okay.
Oh yes.
Just tell them. Smart. Tell them we went to the east. If they ever ask about anything, send them to the east. All right. The opposite direction of where we need to go. That would really help us out. And we did save your life and I did ruin your rug, but I do need to keep it. But it's just in pieces around my spirit weapon. But other than that, that's all we need from you. Right. Yes.
Tell them that you heard we killed a god.
Yeah.
You heard it. Yeah. It was mm-hmm. true.
Oh, or okay. She gets sent. Well, that sounds a little derivative.
Oh, okay. Well, you can just deny ever knowing us. Just deny ever knowing us. They're not good people and they're after this, your trident. So if you could just say, I sold it to someone.
That dirty trident shouldn't be in the hands of anyone nefarious. It has eaten my compost pile and turned it to nothing too many times.
Exactly.
Yeah, they're bad people.
They're bad people.
Why don't you just take your medication? Just calm down.
So if you could do us a favor there and just.
Sandra, Sally. Sally, is that you?
Oh, no. Oh, yes, it is.
You take my medication.
Oh, okay.
Mr. Farmer,
this took a turn for the
awakening. I gotta be honest, Mr. Farmer. I feel really bad for what happened to you with all the crappy magic and chanting. But you know what? We actually, if you need anything else, we do actually have a sorcerer with us. If maybe, Clara, you want to help him out with something?
Yes, the one thing I know about myself is I'm lazy and I like shortcuts. So if composting can grow faster, that's great. If a house servant can wash dishes for me and make my bed, that's great.
I can give you Timothy Chalamet for my my manservant.
Timothy Chalamet.
Okay.
Should I think
no relation.
Yeah, as long as you can keep the other people off the trail of this very dangerous weapon that you
will.
You should give him Timothy Chalamet. He's so frail.
So Timothy Chalamet A, the accent on the second A.
Timothy Chalamet A. I know who he is, but who is he to you, Zabu?
You know, he's my manservant. Is that what you're asking?
Yes. He's your warlock. Oh, he's your okay. I forgot.
I have an unseen servant.
Yes, your unseen servant. Okay, perfect. And he, how long does he, what's his deal?
What's his deal?
Maybe we don't tell him, but he only lasts an hour.
Oh.
But okay, he can get some serious chores done in that hour.
Yeah. What do you have to instruct your servant, right? What does he do?
Yeah, exactly. So I can, you can mentally command the servant, move up to 15 feet, interact with an object. He can perform simple tasks that a human servant can do, such as fetching things, cleaning, mending, folding clothes, lighting fires.
That's exactly what this guy
food,
needs.
Pouring wine.
Dude, Timmy Shell can just take this whole place and fix it up.
T-Shell's got that.
Yeah, T-Shell, dog. T-Shell.
For an hour.
Yeah.
He's got some singed rugs to take care of.
And he just kind of appears, and the farmer goes, well, all right, son, nice to meet you. I'm Pilar. Let's see this at work. What can he do? Make me a sandwich.
And he does it. Look at him.
He makes a great sandwich. It's egg salad.
My favorite.
Egg salad with tomato, apparently.
There's a cornichon on it. He's so French.
With a little bit of pepper.
He's salt based.
Mustard, oil.
Toasted the bread.
Yes, I will tell anyone delicious. Who comes my way to go due east. My life has been saved. My chores are going to be done.
Egg salad.
Happy old farming man.
Stop eating his sandwich, Vork.
I can't. It's free.
All right, thank you, sir.
One. It's fine. He needs a snack anyway.
Let's go to Mondopolis.
Let's go. But before we leave, I'm going to examine the compost heap to make sure nothing else creepy is going to come out of there. Okay.
Ooh, awesome. Good call. Love it.
I rolled a 15, and I investigated with one, so 16.
16 to investigate the remnants of the. Okay, so right now it's a compost heap. He's actually resorted to putting it into a barrel, a container. Mm-hmm. But you know that this is where it's been. You see the pile and you kind of move it away. And what you see is like three pokes in the ground where the pitchfork probably was. Even though it was 2 weeks ago, it was in there pretty deep. And you do see you do see some remnants, not really spores, but some remnants of mushroom stalks kind of sprinkled mm-hmm. around. It's hard to distinguish them from the grass itself, but with your tracking and investigation, you can see them dragging towards the road, and you can see multiples of them on those tracks dragged towards the road. The ones that are there look more dead and decaying, more like fungus Gus's pile as well. Mm. So there's nothing really, well, yeah, there's nothing really.
They got up and moved away. The good ones got up and moved.
Yeah, the ones that they gained, they seem to have gained sentience. And
wow. I'm sorry, there was a trail?
Like a little, yeah, you could track where the mushrooms dragged themselves.
Oh,
Mister,
do we have to follow that or
no?
No, we're going to
Mondopolis. We're going to Mondopolis.
Yankle Tinkle.
I'm yeah. really stuck on the follow the origin, but I'm going to let that go now.
Oh yeah, follow okay. the origin. Oh yeah, that was the clue, right?
But then isn't follow the origin to find where the trident was taken? We already found that.
Okay, that's we right. did. So let's go. Okay,
well, that's the origin of where the trident was. Yeah.
Mister Pilars, before we take off, I want to ask just one more favor of you, if possible. Could I take a small clipping from your rose bush outside just for myself?
What?
I just need just a little, like a bud, if that's okay.
Yeah. What?
I'm sorry, Mr. Pilar. He doesn't need the bud. He hasn't taken his medication either.
I need it.
So excited about my egg salad sandwich. What else do you want? You want a bud? Take a bud.
Great.
Want some apples? Got some apples.
Maybe.
Take some apples.
Yes.
Take some apples. We'll definitely take some apples. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Is there anything to loot off the armor that died or no?
Yeah,
that's a really good question. You could, I guess the chest plate wasn't really destroyed. So I would say that you could wear it. The armor's for a medium-sized person. And it's
sorry.
Not
it just engulfs you.
I mean, no. I killed it.
It's yeah.
You can sleep in it.
But we can sell it.
Yeah.
We could sell it. We could sell it. Also, I can wear heavy armor. So it actually would fit me, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you're a human. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Guys, fine. I got a new outfit.
Yes,
this is amazing.
Fetch. Awesome.
Oh, very fetch. Gosh.
Good. Well, I feel good about this. I've upgraded something today. Like
nice you look not better before.
You smell like puke.
Wow.
I'm
yeah,
so
you smell
sorry.
Horrible.
Yes. Still yes. smells stinky.
I think we need a group hug. I just think that we need to hug it out
okay.
for just a second.
All can right. Tink not be a part of the group hug? She
really smells really
well,
bad.
Well, this fine. I don't want to be a part of the group hug anyway.
You do. Don't you lie. You do.
It's just for us people.
So Pilar says, well, if you're going into town, I can point you to where his shop is so you can get there right away.
Great.
Fantastic.
If you want the stupid dead pitchfork, that's fine. What is it that you want to do with it, by the way? Because I just have to say,
we're quarantining it. We're quarantining it. Yeah,
yes,
take it away from people.
Destroy it.
Yeah, we don't want it to get out there.
We would
it's
never
dangerous.
Use it
it's gonna be in the world. Yeah.
Okay, then I'm gonna give you directions to his shop. Kind of point you in Mondopolis where he is, and then I'm gonna give you a few words from me to Yankle Tinkle.
Oh, good.
Okay. And there are going to be some
Robin, Clara, make sure you remember
this. Write
them
down so I don't actually have
Yankle Tinkle. You want me to write it down?
Oh, no.
Well, Robin's going to relay this message.
No,
there's
cursing involved. It's a string of angry.
I'll also just like riff on it a little bit so we'll throw our own stuff in there.
Yeah, that'd be
And I'll explain it all to my son.
Yeah. So you all could, if this is resolved, you could make it back to Mondopolis. It would be really late at night, probably at this point. But he said, "You're also welcome to stay in my barn."
No.
We gotta go.
We gotta go. That's a bad idea because those other people are fast and
very
get what
generous
they do.
Offer, though. Thank you.
Thank you. Have fun with Charlemont, Tay, Nay. What?
You're killing it with Timothy.
Firmest thing from his name.
Chalamet. I think we're gonna get along.
Tisha.
Just fine.
Great.
Okay.
So Vorpal, on the way out, I do take a bud, a clipping from the rose bush, and I pull out my pot of awakening.
Oh,
and I'm give going the guy to... a chance.
There's a reason for anything. Please. Okay, there's a reason. For
I didn't say anything.
I know what I'm doing. I'm going to plant the rosebud in the pot of awakening. Put a little bit of soil in there. Get a little bit of water, and just let it chill.
Okay. You know, because you remember that Fungus told you about the pot of awakening, like, hey man, just wait 30 days and see what happens, right? So you're trying to feed it rosebuds, or just make the pot comfortable?
Well, you know what? I don't know what it's gonna do. I just know there's some stuff in there. I figure, hey, it's a pot, why not plant something in it? So I'm gonna put some rosebud in there.
You're killing
another plant.
Wait, no. So you're cutting a flower off a plant and expecting it to grow in dirt?
Because you can clone plants by taking clippings off. I'm assuming it's one of those.
Succulents. You can do that to succulents.
And a variety of other plants.
Not roses.
Including banana trees, but there wasn't one of those available.
Succulents around?
Okay.
You can't
in this magical, you know what? In this magical world, I think I can have my rose bush.
I was going to say. We had an animated piece of armor, but no plants.
No.
No rose bush.
Draw the line.
I love that we're just throwing shade at his bombing skills.
No, okay, fine. Yes, you can do that. The other thing that happens, we're almost done here. But Jeff, will you roll
By the way, everybody in chat, you can grow roses from cuttings. You can grow roses from cuttings.
Oh, there's horticulturists watching us right now saying that you can, in fact, do this.
Thank you. I happen to know about this.
That is really funny.
Mark, will you roll a straight up wisdom check?
Sure.
D20 plus wisdom.
9.
Ooh.
Okay.
Wisdom, is there...
Yeah, plus you really like yourself right now. You're doing great. Everything's great. Nothing.
All right.
I have no extra information for you.
Wait, oh no.
Can I do a wisdom check?
Everyone can do a perception check. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Everybody do a perception check.
No. I didn't.
I rolled a 20. I promise I rolled a 20.
Okay.
No.
A natural 20 plus 3.
I did not.
Okay. I want to tell.
I promise.
Okay.
I believe you.
2. Amy, what'd you get?
14.
Okay. Robin?
I got 18.
Ooh, okay. Blades?
16.
Oh, okay, great. Vork, you're like wrapped in plastic, right? You're in saran wrap?
Yes, I am. I like couches. Yeah.
Yeah, you're still
wrapped. Oh, that's right.
You guys, you just see like a, on his back is like, it's throbbing more than it usually is, his black head.
Oh, the back knee. Oh, mm-hmm.
Oh no.
Oh my God. Are you
pull
okay,
out my
Lord?
Dagger.
Wait, the dermatologist. Is...
I'm the healer. Should I look closer at this black head?
You should.
Yeah, please do that.
Do we really need to be doing that right now?
Everybody come and look. I'm going to do an extraction. I was a facialist.
No, no, that show makes me yak.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to look at it and I'm
going to. How are you going to look at it? Bork, are you going to allow, like, you would have to de saran wrap and de arm?
I mean, am I in pain?
Do we really need to be doing this right now? Is this important?
You
cleric pimple popper.
How do they see it if it's I'm in armor and
it's throbbing.
You're moving. Your armor is throbbing.
It's animating independently. Oh, you're
I'll take it off.
Are you flexing your lat or are you flexing your lat or is something going on under your armor?
Don't you have intense back muscles or something?
I do. I worked out this morning. Yes.
It's all back.
Yeah, but this is not that, you guys. This is
so you guys decline staying the night, but then immediately Bork takes off his clothes.
Listen.
Okay,
we just need to take care of this one thing and then we're on the road, okay?
I'm completely naked though, right?
No.
Yes, you're wearing nothing under the armor.
Yes, that's how I roll.
Felicia, Codex, you're kind of looking at this blackhead. It was throbbing and kind of moving independently. Mm-hmm. It doesn't look like you can see where the blackhead's where the source of it comes from. It looks like it's somehow
an enormous, like it's a bigger lump. It's a very muscly blackhead.
Jesus,
a muscly.
You can't tell where Vork ends and blackhead begins.
That's how he described
himself. And you wonder why he's single.
And but it actually does look like it goes pretty deep in. Like so fist. It's like maybe six inches out and then like a foot in. Is it
a foot into his body?
Is it talk?
It's 6 inches out, so like, yeah.
How wide is it?
Jesus Christ!
It's a fucking iceberg blackhead here.
Yeah,
90% of it's under the water.
Does it hurt? Okay.
Can it throw up on Tink?
No.
It's pointed at Tink.
Look like a blackhead, or does it look like it's undulating?
What happened?
Okay, I'm gonna take off.
It has stopped undulating now.
Okay, guys, I'm so sorry, but I'm gonna have to lance this. I take a needle and I need to lance this thing because there's something going on.
Okay.
All right, Tink, stand behind him. I'm going to get in front.
Okay, everybody back off. I've got to lance this. There's something under the skin here. Have I ever seen anything like this before? Should I roll a medicine check or something?
No, you've never seen anything like this before.
I rolled a 17 on medicine, plus 3. Okay, so can I lance it with my medicine skills?
Sure, yeah. You take a very clean needle of work. You feel safe. You lance it,
very
you
safe, feel yes. safe.
Stick it in, and it goes, ow.
Oh, no.
Boo-boo?
It's a baby.
It's your twin.
And I think that's where we're going to stop.
Oh, no, that's hilarious.
Blades takes off.
Wait, what?
Peace, guys.
Who is it?
What's inside him?
Find out next week.
So good.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Always stop when the back knee talks. Like that's
you can't top that.
Can't beat that as a black.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
So the next episode will be the talking blackhead. The Guild plays D&D. The talking blackhead.
I mean, I guess we could do 3 hours of you talking to a blackhead.
I bet
it could be a blackhead. It might not be a blackhead. What if it's like Rubu?
What if it's something? I mean, clearly blackheads don't talk, or at least in my experience, they haven't.
But Vork started the adventure with the blackhead. He's had this with him the whole time.
Oh, maybe it's just that. Didn't you have like a little twin that had like a better pee-pee than you or something?
That was a construct.
That was the illusory fork.
Oh.
Wait a second. Okay, so wait. He came into this venture with a blackhead, just to be clear, right?
But then something happened to it when we went in there, right?
Oh, yes. Oh. He went in the water.
In the water.
Oh my god, this is why you don't swim in ponds.
You don't?
But it talks.
Is that a rule?
Or we gotta let you go, buddy.
Never swim in a pond.
Maybe he thought it was a blackhead, but it never was a blackhead.
Oh my god.
We gotta put you down, man. I'm sorry.
Jesus. All right.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Thanks, you guys. Thanks to the audience. We had a great audience this week. Hopefully you guys can come back. We're going to do 3 more on Sunday night starting at 7 p.m. Pacific. Yeah. Well, next episode, we'll find out what's in Bork.
That's my blackhead.
The one with the talking blackhead. Oh,
we'll find out what the blackhead is.
Oh, my God. And thank you very much to XSplit for making this whole campaign happen. Woo! Thank you to the mods for handing out all those awesome codes from XSplit. If you guys are interested in XSplit, please use our little referral code. Just click on the little box there. Thank you, Amy, for being an incredible DM.
Thank you, Amy. Yes.
Except for giving us a talking blackhead.
Awesome.
And exactly. And Ryko and Sean behind the scenes. So thank you so much, you guys. We'll see you. I will be streaming with Tink. Amy, we're going to be playing Stardew Valley on Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. And on Friday too. And then we'll see you guys back here on Sunday. Thank you, guys.
Oh,
thank
Amy. You. Amy, yeah. I think Sean actually wants us to get a cast photo real fast.
Oh okay.
Cast photo.
Great idea.
What do we do?
Just like for 10 seconds, do what we did before. Slowly increase. Oh, like be happy and slowly increase to as happy.
I was going to do mine.
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
I don't know what the heck.
Okay.
That was the worst.
All right. Bye, you guys.
Bye.
Thank you.